Baller alert. Make it rain,
fly. I'm lurking.
Jumped out of bed. What I'm about to eat. Accomplishing my tasks. I rinse it and repeat.
I'm lurking.
My Rocky cutscene started 2016. Thank you God for my fam. They're like Adrian to me. Now I'm bursting at the seams. Money growing steadily. Said don't chase the money, let the money chase me. Wouldn't be myself without the lessons I've seen. Travis Scott to chase me, Rock Nation Jay-Z. City Girls JT, Drizzy Drake 40. Ice-T, Arnold P, TB12 Gronkowski. J-Pros crazy dreams, when I pass I'll grow my wings. Every day when I wake up I
say
a prayer.
I'm lurking,
my being
I'm lurking.
I jump out of bed, what I'm about to eat. Investing in myself, it's working perfectly. Now my family, they believe. Now my mama, she can see.
I'm lurking. Hello?
Alright.
We hope for a good performance today. Please pray for good performance. I mean, technically.
My Rocky cutscene started 2016. Thank you God for my fam.
Last night the laptop couldn't handle one single boss in Elden Ring for almost an entirety of a stream. Fuck me. But hey, he hit the tips goal massively and destroyed it.
Guidance counselor shouting.
And I think Tevin was live literally the whole time. From before DSB started with the stream to literally this morning when I woke up. I don't know if he had any downtime. He was lurking and stalking.
I'm lurking. I'm lurking.
Make me happy. That's the science of achievement. The art of fulfillment while I'm grinding patiently. I must be running towards my goals if I want money chasing me. So I jumped out of bed. What I'm about to eat. I thought I was out the game, made a full recovery. Porsche 911 like a tangerine dream, but I won't. Push P.
I'm lurking, I'm lurking.
Pointers in the paddock get my peace. I'm push a pee.
Me.
Got no hammers for my pee. We don't want no peace.
Me.
Got a spot across the spot.
Just pay my taxes.
Drop the data now we plan.
Pay my taxes.
You get a real fucking.
She not a lesbian for peace. She turned lesbian. Push a pee.
Hello.
A capital P, I write the president, count president. Push Portuguese on her knees, my banana pee. She let me squeeze and she leave, cause she keep the pee.
You're bagging.
Private suite, privacy, bitch, I'm pushing pee.
Scumbag.
Purple paint, pussy paint, bitch, I'm pushing pee.
I love
push
my
pee. I'm pushing pee.
That was
push
my
pee.
Depression.
Pushing pee. Yeah.
I'm lurking.
Push a pee. I'm push a pee. Push a pee. I'm push a pee. Yeah.
Alright, what's up you guys? It's an early stream today. No camera because my laptop can't handle it apparently.
Push a pee.
I got way too many hats on.
Push a pee.
And yeah, this is a stream. We're gonna summarize literally all that happened yesterday from a DSP standpoint. And then, I don't know, watch some other shit. I don't fucking know. I have nothing planned. I just sat down here and started recording.
Push pee. I just fucked a cup of water. Push a pee. Push a pee, red bandana card.
Push
a pee. I'ma pee you at your whole endorsement. She ain't vanilla for me, she simply pushed. I never saw ops, now we finally touched.
DSP can knock you out in a minute, in Street Fighter and in real life.
You're still on mission one.
Yeah.
Pay my taxes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Me.
Yeah.
Me.
Yeah.
Me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree with you.
Yeah.
You're still on mission one.
Yeah.
You're still on.
What? Baller alert.
You're gonna hop on my car.
Baller alert.
Billy Cool Rider with
stars. Lurking.
What? I keep a baller alert. Hey. Yo. She get the top in the draw. Yo.
Hey. You're bagging.
Diamonds, they weigh on my arm.
You're still on mission one. Arm.
Test on my neck, I'm on my arm. Diamonds, they weigh on my arm.
I need to probably turn down the latency to this stream. I think shit is gonna be delayed.
Oh, and this bitch going crazy. Yo, I whip this shit like a baby. Yo.
The company leads for now production and internet content.
When he said, tall, y'all mean.
What?
Shorty wanna kick it with the team.
What?
I got all this walk on me.
Walk.
Shorty wanna ball with the team.
I'm lurking.
Did Elden Ring save the stream? Absolutely. He had over 1,000 views at some point. He was like the biggest streamer on YouTube. It's like back in the day. And then we're gonna look at his channel, but the views started to fizzle out already. Like he was fighting the same fucking boss. That first stream was the worst, man. That shit was so bad. He hit the tip goal. What else can we say? You can't dispute cash. And he got a lot of super chats. Bill, let's get to the game.
I don't know what game are you talking about. The arbitrary game that we're gonna be playing?
Look at him. Look at him. What?
Yeah.
Look at him. What? Fuck the nigga. Oh, fuck the nigga.
And it was basically a masterclass in DSP. I haven't seen a more DSP stream than that one. I can say that. In recent years, I haven't seen any of them. He gave the trolls a little bit of a rant because Tevin was back, and I was doing my shit, and Froggo was doing the shit. Of course, DDM has two streams going on. So yeah, everybody was out watching. It was like the Super Bowl. And if you're European, it was like the UEFA Champions League, I guess. And yeah, man, he got a super chat from Review Tech USA. What else happened? It was all the clown modes. Every single type of clown mode was on that night. And CPU is back at 40%. I don't know what to do. I don't know what the fuck is going on. Alright. Alright, some more music and we're gonna talk about that shit.
In New York, I'm
Is there a Snort Burnell on that? I'm gonna check it out.
I'm lurking. Baller alert.
And he made $60 on the night stream. Is there like a unrecorded begging segment? Oh, this is so fucking good. Didn't save the businessman. He was fighting the same guy over and over and over again on the premiere stream. His biggest stream of the year. He was fighting the same guy. But it was a success because he got the views and the engagement. So he's gonna learn from that to do exactly this. Fuck around and sit there for attention. And yeah, he called people bitches. Oh, fuck. Good afternoon, KWO. I'm in the afternoon here, but some people are in the AM. Which, that's why I'm playing Playboi Carti, because they gotta get lit.
I'm lurking.
Get a real fucking shot.
What a great fucking Phil stream. Oh yeah, and a whale left. Holy shit, that new cat in the vest. The vest wasn't new, but it was, it was something. I don't know, man. This was like, it was so bad. Yeah, this is the hypest song. This for the Americans that are still partying in the AM and taking shots and throwing money at strippers. But if you're doing this, you're probably not watching this stream. You know what you should do? You should put this stream on a TV somewhere and bump it up while you get like strippers to come over. That's the fucking best thing.
I'm lurking.
Scumbags and mental based on the internet still support me.
Alright, we should probably start at this point. Let's see. What is on the agenda today? Is there some clips? First, I need some clips. He called people bitches, yeah, he called them pussies, I think. Yeah, a bunch of pussies. Let's see the more streamlined clip. Okay. Let me just tell Playboi Carti to fuck off. Alright. Okay.
Alright.
Alright. Hello, everybody. This is an early lurk stream. That's a thing, I guess. Since DSP can name anything with a catchy name, and it's gonna be a thing, then this is the early lurk.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
If you're listening to this, then it's either really early for you or it's really late or it's somewhere in between. Okay. You know what the drill is? Watching Phil. He had a great stream last night. We're going to summarize that, go over the highlights, lowlights, and complete lack of lights. And then I'm going to fuck off, I guess. All right, big ups, chat, for being here this late or this early or right in time. Reminder to clock in immediately. Otherwise, there's going to be strict punishment. Not from me, of course. From my bosses. Let's see, DSP called his chat a pussy. Somebody a pussy. And not having balls.
All right, I'm going to just say this once.
But this was the night stream. So obviously, Tip's goal is at 26. And the persona of having... of being a great streamer is not here.
As you guys know, there's no derailing allowed. We're not talking about world
there's
events.
No derailing allowed
politics. We're not talking about anything on the stream but Elden Ring. You can talk about other things gaming related, but as you know, that's not what my stream's about. If I see you talking about it, I'm gonna time you out and end up banning you, and I don't want to. Okay, I don't want to, but obviously if people are gonna completely derail the stream, I gotta do something about it, right? Okay,
big up Shinko for the clock in.
So this is Ashes of War.
It's helping us keep a good attendance.
Ashes of War to grant skills and affinities to your armaments as sites of grace. And we know it can only have one skill.
Oh, what is this? Why are we back to reading menus? I have PTSD from fucking yesterday. Hey, he fought a dragon. Very exciting.
He tried to bite. What happened? Where'd my horse go? Oh, shit. At least I'm at this bonfire.
Death counter is 45, and he died like 37 times to one guy. Like, actually one guy. Which is like, it's bad, but you could have done literally anything else. Could have gone anywhere and do anything on your fucking stream to entertain 1,000 people. And no, he was just trying to brute force this same guy. What, he read a guide?
Dragon has a dick or not.
Of course he read a fucking guide.
You don't know. Okay, excuse me.
I need to play the game myself to figure that out.
All right, guys, so...
Oh my god, he read a guy.
Give me like a minute. I'm just going to take a piss.
In a piss break.
Reapply ourselves.
Fucking nice.
Thank you for the views. Thank you for the likes. Thank you for the support. It would be great if we get some more support. Remember, guys...
Thank you for the views.
real life Sir Dumas hat to wear if we hit $100.
Real life Sir Dumas. This is, by the way, I saw from Shinko's Twitter. This was like $15 on Amazon. This shit is ass. It's literally ass. It's a terrible fucking hat. And it's low quality for the premiere stream that he made $200.
Oh, we did get a lot of good support on the earlier.
Oh, bro.
Do it again tonight, but give me a minute. I'll be right back.
And now he's gone. This is the quality that you are conditioned to enjoy. This is what you're conditioned to enjoy from fucking Phil. He's conditioned you to like
okay,
this.
Guys, I'm back.
So you're actually...
The Brick Boy.
His fans are sitting there and enjoying this actively.
Thank you to the Brick Boy for
active
the
enjoyment.
Get that added to the total. And then we'll resume here, try to fight this dragon again. So we're currently at $40 in tips, guys. Again, at $50, it's Gunner Glasses. At $100, it's a silly,
I hate this.
Real-life Dumas
hat. I hate
this. Okay, cool.
It's this silly hat. How many times is he going to hit that goal, huh? How many times do you think?
All right, we're going to go and reapply ourselves.
Playing Elden Ring. It's going to be another fucking week. It's going to be, hey, guys, we haven't seen this hat especially for this, in real life, Sir Dumas. But we can't hit the goal. I can't wear the hat unless we hit the tips goal for support.
You could jump over it.
Just like with every fucking... with everything he does, it's always like that. It burns out, and eventually it's like, hey, you guys, I think it's going away.
By the way, I hate to say it, I've never met a bigger bunch of pussies than some of these people in the stream
what
chat. Just leave, you just run away, fight them later, go do other stuff, come back later,
bro.
Why?
They're bored, they're not pussies. What do you mean pussies? It's fucking ridiculous. This is the second stream, by the way. It's not the first one.
Have you ever played a From Software game before?
First one was worse, by the way.
Have you ever played Soulsborne? This is the fun of the game.
What if I haven't played it and I want to watch a streamer play it? And the streamer calls his stream the best playthrough ever. And I tune into that guy and I trust him. You know what? This guy claims is the best fucking playthrough. I bet he's really skilled and he knows what he's doing. And then he dies 35 times to the same guy in a game where you could go into any direction and fight anybody. He dies to the same fucking guy in the best playthrough ever. Imagine what the worst playthrough ever is going to be.
Throw yourself at it. You learn the patterns. You get better. And then you overcome. That's the fun of the game. Why would I run away like a pussy till I'm over-leveled by fighting other things and then come back and steamroll it? This is fun to me. I'm having a
this
lot
is
of fun
to
right
me.
Now. People who say that you're a pussy. My God, you don't understand how to play these fucking games. This is the joy of it, is to learn and get better and get better and get better and then overcome what you're fighting. Not go fucking over level like a bitch, like a fucking wimp.
Over level like a bitch.
Holy shit.
Wow. No, it's called just playing the game.
What
the fuck
is that?
What? Do you think you're supposed to die 35 times to an literally optional guy?
But I did it. Why would I run like a bitch?
Oh, by the way, when that's a good one. Spoonitan is saying in chat, didn't he run from Jaha though? He did exactly that. He was a pussy bitch in real life, not even in the video game. He didn't want to fight the real boss. Instead, he ran away. He didn't even go grind and fight like weaker guys at Evo or whatever. He just went to cry in the bathroom.
Come back later.
Practice what you preach, Dark One.
Dragon bitch.
Dark man.
We
were gonna beat his ass, man.
They were
gonna beat his ass so bad.
Play the game, man. Play the fucking game.
Phil's constantly talking shit, man.
The dragon's tough.
He deserves it.
Oh, that's definitely how stuff gets done in life, to run away from all those difficult challenges and problems, right?
Bro, you're literally the...
Go head on.
What?
Smash your fucking
head. The guy that just says, I hope for the best. Just ignore everything and hope for the best. This is his life advice, by the way. Ignore everything, hope for the best. But now he's going to be giving you advice as if he's somebody who should be giving advice.
Against it a million times until finally either your head explodes into a million...
Yeah, he ran from Keemstar as well. That's right. He ran away from Keemstar, blocked him, talked shit about him, unblocked him, talked some more shit, blocked him again. Fucking nice. Big ups Jay Ruiz for the dollar super chat.
There you go. That's how you play these games. All right. So we got to go save again, and then I want to lift for you. Thank you very much to Jamaica Phil.
Jamaica Phil.
So now we're $45 in tips, guys. Only $5 away from the Gunner glasses. I really, by the end of the night, would like to wear the hat. We got about a half an hour left on the stream, roughly, okay? Please, if you like the stream, if you like what's going on, please give it a like, of course, if you're watching on demand. If you're watching on demand on YouTube, give it a
and
like.
Just generic begging.
Let me know what you think about me so kicking the dragon's ass, okay?
What do you think about me? I'm going to check out his comments after this video.
Shit.
Let's actually see the comments. What are they saying?
So,
Phil, I'm so excited. This is the most excited I've been watching somebody fight the same enemy for half an hour, even more. Yesterday, it took him 28 minutes to make a character. I timed it. Then also, you can see my timestamps in the difference between the start of the game and when that game actually starts. It was like 45 minutes from him checking audio, then having audio issues. But yeah.
It's down here, possibly. But anyway, I want to get back on the horse. And I want to go to this...
The technical difficulty, I'm going to cover that as well. I'm going to look at that up. I just started, basically.
They're
and
back.
last night I tuned out. I went and watched a little bit of Tevin because he was live. Then I just went and I played Cyberpunk for like 6 hours straight until like 4 a.m. or some shit. And then I slept and then I woke up and now I'm here. So yeah, this was my day. This was a Meerkat day off.
And they look exactly the same.
Can I explain my whole soundboard in the stream? I can probably make a video about it because I like explaining stuff. And if you care about stuff being explained to you, I can do it in a very detailed way. It's just not on a stream because it's, like, boring.
Look at the rat!
I can do a video about it.
Oh, shit! The miner!
Because I would understand some people not understanding where this comes from.
DSP can knock you out in a minute. In Street Fighter and in real life.
Or this.
I need to put disgusting food in the mouths of my family members.
You know what I mean?
You son of a bitch. He's like, you attack my pet rat, you piece of shit. You fucking.
Oh, they have big rats in this game? Holy shit. I love games that have big rats in them.
You kill my rats? I got fucked up. What are you talking about? I'm a liar head. I don't know. We're okay now. Guys, I'm only playing for about another 15, 20 minutes tops.
Massive big ups to Heal versus Babyface.
So if you're like
for the massive, massive, massive support, a round of applause, please, chat and prayer hands. Massive thank you. Big ups, Heal versus Babyface.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking.
Thanks a lot. Now let's get back to Phil.
What you're seeing today, I urge you, please come back tomorrow.
Actually, if I could have,
into the meat of the game.
If I could have the camera on, I would put on all the hats, but I can't.
If you like the stream.
Stream is very unstable. I'm balancing it on several limbs right now.
This video on
it's like
on
a Dark Souls boss.
Means, give it a like. Give, leave a comment. Let me know what you think about the game. Let me know what you think about my gameplay. The fact that I decided to fight these bosses head on instead of being a puss. And also, last chance to support. It really would be great if we could get more support tonight. Support tonight's been pretty good with super chats. The tips have been... Oh, shit. There was something else to do there. There was something else there.
Why is this still in the video?
We'll have to figure this out tomorrow. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, is he signing off? Okay, 65. That's something, man.
I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. I actually
65. It's a something.
I was going to. Now that the game is open world, I'm on a horse. I'm kind of understanding the new game mechanics.
He's on a horse. He's on cat.
Not that hard to control, although you do have to hold the controller differently to use it, which is kind of a little bit annoying. But it was fun. Man, I liked fighting those tough bosses. That was extra fun to take on the tough bosses. The horseman at the beginning of the stream today, and then that dragon.
Did he beat the horseman, though?
That was fun.
I'm actually kind
of
curious.
You guys enjoyed it. And keep in mind, I am playing a lot of this coming up. Another whole day of it tomorrow, depending on how tomorrow goes. And if you guys want more of it, maybe another day. We'll see. But I am had a ton of fun. 54 deaths.
54 deaths.
All
right.
Views were great. Likes were great.
Support views were an all-time high.
This stream was a little bit slower.
To be honest.
But earlier today, the first stream was outstanding. So thank you guys so much. I hope that you enjoyed it. I will be back more soon.
Fucking
if you're
nice.
Watching this video on demand on YouTube.
Oh, yeah. Okay. He forgot to beg for YouTube engagement. Please. They wasn't going to do it. They weren't going to do it at all.
Favor.
Oh, good thing I remembered to shoehorn this shit in their heads.
And leave comments on the video.
Leave comments. Say,
what do you think about the premiere day of Elden Ring? Leave comments. Did you enjoy it? What should I know that I don't know? What have I missed out on? Right?
And he's literally the same guy as everybody he's making fun of. And there's nothing inherently bad with asking people to leave a comment about what they think, because that's why comments are there. And that's, you know, you should sometimes tell people to do something. Like, you can like this stream right now, which is a cool thing you can do. You don't have to, but you can do this. But he makes fun of people that do it, and then he does it himself way after the fact, when it's not even, like, a thing that people even do all that much. Oh, fuck. Yeah, let's see the daily rap first. This has 500 views for 4 hours. For 5 hours. Daily rap. The daily rap. He's fucking quiet. Oh, it's under 3 minutes.
Friday, February 25th, 2022. Or as people like to call it, Elden Ring Day.
Elden Ring Day.
I had so much fun today.
I had so much fun. What? Are you fucking serious?
Today, I forgot to film this video. I uploaded all the other videos. I had everything ready to go.
Wow, excitement. The dollar sign excitement. That's the excitement.
Wait a minute, I forgot to do something. Shit. I forgot the daily rep. I was happy.
Because
so
much because he got all this money, then he was like, fuck this, I'm gonna clock out. Ah shit, I forgot to do the daily rap. Now I have to go there and just like say that everything was amazing.
Stuff that I needed to do.
But I'm gonna get some views out of it, so let's go do it.
So the Elden Ring, guys.
Sounds good.
It's great. It started out a little slow, and admittedly, it felt just like Dark Souls. I'm telling everyone.
Wow, what a surprise.
All right, it is.
The most fucking awesome guy.
Exactly the same gameplay mechanics with a jump and reduced fall damage. And a horror.
Bro, this is what fucking irritates me. That this guy can be fucking sitting there and fighting the same guy for 2 hours and do the character creator for 30 minutes and do bullshit for 2 hours before all of that. And he gets 1,000 people to tune into him. And then there's people with like 1,000 subs. I'm not talking about myself at all. I'm not even like a real YouTuber. I just talk shit about Phil. But people that do edits of stuff and talk about games and reviews, and they have to do so much more grind than this guy, who all he has to do is be delusional and repeat to you the same thing over and over again until you believe it. Until you believe it for long enough, until you realize you actually don't like him, and then you go watch somebody else.
Changes the game a lot.
Probably.
And I had so much.
Probably that's how it goes.
Bosses that were not needed to be fought at the beginning of the game, but I fought them anyway, and I persevered today. Optional areas, two optional dungeons that I explored. And
optional dungeons.
Bosses today. It was super fun. I had a great time. If you want to see the gameplay, it's all live or should be live shortly on DSP Gaming. All
right, let's see DSP Gaming. Let's see another. Another channel audit, because I love doing those, because it's always kind of the same thing. It's just his channel is bad. So spoilers, his channel is bad. Now, of course, the fucking thumbnail for the daily rap is as if his cows got on fire or something. He's just sitting there in desperation. But meanwhile, he loved it. Then the playthrough part one. I'm going to go through this if my laptop allows me. Yeah, it actually will. He starts with just a cough storm of a storm of coughing. Then we get nonsense for the first actual 35 minutes, literally 35 minutes until gameplay comes in. Like the actual first thing you can do in the game. I think, right? He didn't fight the boss. No, he was just making his guy 35 minutes. Then we go some walking around, some tutorial stuff. I think he died to the first boss. Yeah, he was the first boss. He died. Then he resurrected in this cave thing. Then he was fucking around. He actually goes outside in, I think, what is called Limgrave at 1 hour 15 minutes. And what you get is a song.
Welcome to Limgrave.
What you get is a fucking song. Now, this is a highlight, by the way. This is 1 hour 15 minutes in. You could have watched an actual movie until now, until he actually started playing the game. I should probably look at Wings playing it so I can see how long it took him, because he doesn't do a pre-stream, and he also, I don't know.
And then you're just dead.
I don't know. He's faster, I guess, but he was stuck on something. I don't fucking know. It's Wings. The beginning. Okay, so he dies. This is part one. He's still dying to the same guy. All right, let's transition to part two, which has been uploaded before part one, because that is how YouTube works. Of course, it's YouTube's fault, you guys. He can't do anything about it. Now, here we have clickbait title. Did I beat Tree Sentinel? First dungeon, boss in the horse. Woo. This is an hour 40 minutes long. He keeps fighting the Tree Sentinel for what seems like an actual hour. Did he beat him? Did he quit him? Did he win? I think he does. Yeah, he does. Wow. Amazing. He beats him 45 minutes into the second part. Then I don't know what happens. Some meandering or some nonsense. Goes to a dungeon or whatever. I wasn't watching that. That was boring. Then we have part 3, which the views have dramatically dropped. Even though the part 3 and part 4, that's from the night stream. We have what? Foot soldiers, a big boy in a surprise encounter. Those all caps in the titles are great. They're very eye-catching. Then we have outlasting a dragon, Limgrave tunnels, boss in a witch. So yeah, he fights the dragon in this one. Is there like a major beg alert? Is he begging a lot? All right. Skip, skip, skip. Flying dragon. Okay, he beat the dragon. He was probably looking up some info or something. I don't know.
Going to come. I guess I killed.
Who's going to come?
It's a cool boss, right?
Oh, is this where the technical difficulties start? I think it does, because there's some noise that's not mine.
Fun!
Fun! Alright, he got a horse, beat a dragon. This guy is great. Then what do we get next?
Well, I want to go to that cave that's in the lake, first of all.
So much fucking fun. He goes in some dungeons.
I don't know where the beach is.
It's whatever. It's just like.
Go make a fill to me $4.20. DSP gameplay.
How does it end though?
I can't level up. I don't have enough. Oh, never mind.
Never mind. Actually, let's go and find out the technical difficulties one, because I'm very interested in that one. And what happened and how the pay pig left. It's a fucking pay pig, man. That son of a bitch. Why would he leave Phil? Phil is completely reliant on your support. How could you leave? And there's a Snort Brunel after that that I'm definitely going to watch. Even though it's kind of the same stuff, it's going to help me summarize what happened last night and the massive confusion that ensued with the DSP getting 1,000 views and major engagement. It literally saved the channel. Oh, here's the unrecorded Elden Ring thing.
All right, I think it's time.
It's time.
Up. I'm actually going to open my blinds. They're closed for some reason. I want to get fresh air in here.
There we go. Whale left in a blaze of super chat. Oh, the super chat thunderstorm. I'm gonna throw money at you and then I'll never come back.
All right. Oh, it looks like it froze again. My stupid video feed froze again. Hold on a second. Let me refresh it.
The video feed froze. What is this? Tech issues. And the thing with DSP is he's not even very good at... He's not very good at troubleshooting stuff, so he probably doesn't even know... Like, he won't even find out where it came from.
Unplug and replug.
But I don't know.
Get it to work. I don't know what happened here.
Okay. I mean, that's your best chance. Just restart it. I know it's a meme, but restarting it is literally the first thing that you say when you work a help desk in tech support. Have you tried restarting it? I know this is cliche. There's
Shit.
There's an unlimited amount of times where I've told people, I'm sorry, you probably heard this before, but have you tried turning it off and then on again? And then they do it and then it works. And I'm like, okay, it's all right. It's all right. It's okay.
Deactivate.
I love you.
Refresh the
I'm gonna close your ticket now, okay? Sounds good. I love closing tickets.
For some reason, it's acting like it's not active, which probably means that the USB cord's loose.
All right, now cords are loose. I thought this was a professional thing. I wonder how he's gonna blame this on everybody else. I wonder why. Sometimes, though, tech support, we would get a ticket for some actual machine that we don't know how it works. Like, I worked in this company for like microprocessors and shit, and one of the machine broke, and I had to fix it. I've never seen a machine like that, but we figured it out.
The whole thing. I don't know why.
Just a network issue.
The device doesn't seem to be working, which is dumb. It was working earlier. Okay, hold on.
Parma spilled tequila on their keyboard. Now computer no work. What do? Put it in some rice. And then take it out of the rice and turn it off and then turn it on. And then put it in rice again. And then take it out. And then put it back in. Phil? When this happens. But this is the risks of being an interactive streamer. Sometimes you're gonna be gone.
Hello?
I'm lurking.
Why is it blinking? I have no idea. And Windows is not triggering.
Windows is not triggering? What? By the way, one of the highlights from last night is immediately after he hit the Vets goal for $150, he put on the vest and he had the audacity to say, "You guys, today it's very hot in my office. I might get really hot in this vest, so I'm gonna switch it out for a different fucking vest." He was this much of a fucking baby. Now I remembered it. I don't know why I remembered it. It was a terrible fucking moment from last night. From yesterday, I guess. Last day. Come on, come back.
Streaming or capturing or running.
All the other cords are plugged in fine.
That's how I felt yesterday. When my CPU would go from 9% to literally 45% for no reason. I couldn't even open a different tab.
The capture device stopped working, but sadly I might have to close and open OBS. I don't know what else to do because OBS is, you know, usually won't allow you to add a new device.
Wait, did the PayPig left because DSP had tech issues?
Fuck with it for a few minutes. Try to get it to work.
That's a strange PayPig.
All right? Give me a minute. The stream's going to go down.
Good PayPigs would usually give him more money so he can buy newer stuff that doesn't break. So he can buy newer technology and treat it like shit and provide absolutely no maintenance to any of it and not update anything, not even restart anything. Just leaves anything running. Because it's running right now and now is good. So if I touch it in literally any way, even if I'm trying to improve it, it's gonna break. And we can't have it break. Or else I'll have to learn something and a way to fix it. We can't have this here. This is not that kind of a stream. It's an interactive, looking at a blank screen and a chair stream. Okay, now we're at, I don't know who that's, I guess, Ann Lee Restream, because we have DSP's chat actually on the screen. Which is something that DSP definitely doesn't want to do on his one. Because that's not what it's about. It's about Phil. It's not about fucking chat. Those people are just there to give money. Why else would they be just sitting there looking at a guy that is not there? And also looking at him talk about a bunch of random stuff earlier and then talk about nothing for, I don't know, and not do anything in the game. Why else would they be there but to give money? Okay. People coming back because the stream restarted. All right, let's skip this. Is he gonna be back? Hopefully.
All right, I think we're good.
We are good.
I don't know why I did that. It seems to me like one of the wires is getting pretty wonky at this point. That sometimes I just boop it and the fucking thing has an error and then the whole thing stops working. And usually what I can do is I can change the resolution. And by changing the resolution...
Okay, here we go. First super chat by him. By some guy, actually. I don't know if it's exactly the guy. The guy that quit. Turbo Pascal. Pro tip. Let your equipment out before going live. Instead of making us wait with our thumbs up, you know what? Very fucking nice. You should give him money to give him advice that is like basic shit.
It just
very nice.
Itself and it works.
Should give him more money to shit on him.
The whole thing aired out as if it wasn't working at all, but it, and it was blinking. And as soon as I restarted the PC, it works fine. So.
Oh no! And now somebody's gonna say, "Oh no! It's fucking, it's DSP's fault for his stream not working." No, am I like a fucking tech professional that I've been working for 40 years in IT and I can fix everything? No, I'm a normal guy. Sometimes something would break, but I don't know what to do.
All right, I don't know how
you don't know anything.
The top five streaming this on YouTube doesn't make any sense. Turbo Pascal, you
top five streaming
about.
On YouTube.
My equipment worked
where did
fine
that come from?
Today. Why would I be on here thinking that it wasn't going to work? In fact, it was working up to the point that I was streaming, and then it malfunctioned on live on the stream. Like, what are you saying? You act like I didn't stream at all today or something, and all of a sudden, out of the blue, this has happened. That's not what happened at all.
I don't know what's happening actually, and now he's going to send him another super chat. I guess
no problem.
The response to this.
Everything was fine.
This is actually the best fucking PayPig interactions. Those are my favorites. When he first, somebody sends him a super chat that is mildly upset or sort of upset, and then DSP just memory calls it and it's like, well, that's not how reality works. That's something else, actually. And then the guy sends him even more money to tell him something else that's going to push the conversation in the same direction as it was going. So DSP is going to say again, well, no, what you're saying is something entirely different from what you actually said, which means it's invalid. It's not real criticism. And this is how all fucking interactions go. And he just can't talk to anybody like a normal person.
That's called life.
Probably because he's not a normal person.
You roll with the punches.
That's called life.
You make sure that you have, you know, think ways to test stuff and fix stuff on the fly, which I do, and I got it working again. What do you want to do?
Yeah, fuck nice.
It's very rare when something like that even happens, which is a good thing. So, okay. Now, back to Elden Ring. Back to what we were about to do when the thing crapped out, right? Thank you, Jade.
He says, all right, Pascal sent him another super chat, and I'm going to tell you, I'm going to read it out because I don't trust DSP with reading it out and interpreting it in the way that it's supposed to be, so I'm going to read it out. And he puts in quotes, my parachute worked when I skydived last week, therefore it should work today. See something wrong with that statement? Okay. Now, this is what the super chat says. Let's see how DSP is going to react to it.
Okay, now it's going to work, I think. Thank you, Turbo Pascal, for the first super chat of the night. All right, we're getting started, guys. We will have 2 hours of gameplay no matter what, I promise you. All right. So, again, sorry for the technical difficulties. If you like the stream, please give it a like. We're trying to get maximum engagement.
Give it a big like, big thumb.
Okay, in addition to that,
of the you know what?
Whether that would be being a channel member. Joining as a member, which will get us a new record of members every time someone joins tonight.
My God, he talks about this so long.
Or a super sticker, or a tip. Tips in particular would help a lot. We have a brand new hat that I am wearing now. What the fuck?
And the thing is that if you look at his chat, because there's a lot of people going like, whoa, what did he say that? Did Turbo Pascal said this? And some people agreeing with him, and you know what I mean. It's like his chat is literally scared of DSP. They are scared of DSP, the way they react. Oh my God, you send him a critical message? Oh, you're on thin ice, man. You're going to be out of here. What? You fucking scared of Phil.
I didn't even know that's what was over there, because this is where I sat down to get the horse.
Big ups Neil Taylor for the 10 Australian super chill dollars with the heart emote.
Cool.
I love you too, dude.
But anyway,
even though I don't know you.
If we do hit,
but you give me money, so I love
tonight,
you.
The new... The brand new.
If you can pay your travel expenses, you can.
Elden
I can ship
Ring,
you across the country.
Dumas in real life hat will be worn if we hit our tips goal.
This
for
sucks
tonight.
Ass. It'll this hat sucks ass.
Awesome. All right, let's get into the gameplay, shall we?
Are you gonna read the super chat?
All right. So Turbo Pascal did another super chat. I can't see it.
Oh, I can't even see it. You fucking asshole. I can't even see it. And he ignored it for long enough. So it's not relevant anymore. He can't see it. Chat can't see it. And everything is okay. What a fucking asshole. And it's the shit like this that you know he saw this super chat. He looks at his chat for validation and for people to agree with him all the time. He saw this guy. He saw him. You know that. We all fucking know that. But he's gonna pretend like he didn't. and then say he's honest, and then say, you guys, I'm the realest fucking guy, the most trustworthy. What? What a bitch.
No, anyway, let's continue.
Anyway, let's continue.
Waste my time. All right.
I'm not going to waste my time. I can't even see it. Didn't acknowledge it, didn't anything. Yeah. No wonder a fucking pay pig went away after this. He got cucked. They literally got cucked by Phil, which is like the lamest thing. The lamest fucking thing. What else happened? Oh, yeah, the Snort Brunel. Let's go. I'm going to skip the intro, though.
Play the game.
Because you already know how chill it is. And I think this covers also the working more than full hours, if you haven't seen this yet.
I'm not a bachelor. I don't have 100% of my life to free time. Enough is enough with these idiots who say dumb shit things like, you should just make more
It's the Turbo guy that left. What was his name? Turbo something. I forgot already. Some guy. I don't really know of him,
for a living.
But apparently he left.
How to learn this software and do animations for your streams? Fuck off. No, really, I mean it. Fuck off. Do it yourself. Go ahead and you learn it.
Oh, there were more super chats, but there was nothing in that video. There was actually nothing left. It was the last thing in the video. There were no super chats. You gotta go find them, I guess. This, a bunch of pussies. This and this and this. Clown mode. Everything is Elden Ring and DSP on my feed. This is what kind of channel this is. Elden Ring and Phil. What the fuck? Tech issues. Were there more super chats? Did he ignore literally all of them? I don't know, man. I guess I gotta look at the Dark Dave thing, but that's like, it's gonna take me a lot of time lurking to figure it out. And it's not here. That's fucking assholes. DSP dude. And this was at the late stream. 5 hours ago, 3 hours ago. I don't know. Let's see this one. I guess. Maybe. He threatened him with a $5 super chat. Man. So this was before he played the game, right? It was like here somewhere. Hadn't played the game yet. Could be here.
This guy.
Nah, he's playing the game. Goodbye. Anyways, I can't fucking find this. Rest in peace to the pay pig. And yeah, you shouldn't have been a pay pig in the first place. Good fucking job. You found out DSP is an asshole. Congratulations. Oh, it was almost there? Okay. Thank you for the guidance. I'm not gonna give up. I'm like Phil. I always keep grinding, keep going, even though my CPU is against me. It's wildly against me. There was something happening here, I guess? Maybe? DSP was offline, then he came back. Okay, here it is. Great investigative work. Thanks, everybody. There it is. The first super chat is here. My parachute super chat is here. I love these fucking chats. And this is what I'm telling you about. That DSP, this is one of the worst things about DSP is how much he lacks any kind of transparency and uses any single situation to twist it to be in his favor. Either by memory calling something or twisting what they said just because you can't see it. But if you watch this stream that has the chat on the screen, you can see anything. And you can see how full of shit he is when he gets called out. And this is, by the way, the least extent you can go to call DSP out. Like, you can't actually confront him in any other way outside of his chat. And if you send him money. That's the only way you can get a message across. And then he's gonna ignore it or twist it.
Stop this. Dumas in real life.
Oh yeah, okay, here he's shilling the hat. Is he gonna ignore this? The super chat? Did he come?
Did
the super chat come through?
I don't know. Skills square off. This skill starts with the sword held level.
Big ups, Saul. 217 for a super chat. Man up and slam your head against the wall. No wonder he's like this. Such wonderful advice and role model. And yeah, that's why his head is in this shape. Because he was slamming it against the wall so much.
Upward to an enemy's
Big up, Saul.
Strong attack.
This should be here.
Thank you to Gabriel K.
Yeah, Turbo Pascal, here it is with the $10 super chat. If you don't read the super chat and the previous one, I'm never contributing again. I tipped you over $200 in one day for your Pokemon Arceus stream last week. Don't test me. It's a PayPig fucking message. Don't test me. And let him see address it, because this is fucking great.
Thank you so much, Gabriel, for that. He says, enjoy the game, Phil. Thank you. All right. Turbo
Don't
Pascal,
fucking test
you
me.
Are complaining about something that doesn't mean anything. You are whining about a technical difficulty that happened out of the blue for equipment that was working on an earlier stream for 5 straight hours for a stream that I had.
No.
Had no. working, and then there was a technical difficulty during the stream. You don't know what you're talking about, and you have no
No, he was talking about that you ignored his super chat. You literally ignored it and said you couldn't read it and that you're not going to bother with stupidity. And that guy who had the stupidity says he sent you over $200.
Ready when it was
Well, he wasn't stupid then, but now he's stupid that he sent you a super chat that you don't agree with.
What
a dumbass.
Like, what you're saying has no merit. So why am I going to
What you're saying has no merit. It's not real criticism.
Right? Right?
You should ban him. Yeah,
okay.
Right.
Let's play the game.
Ban this shithead that just sent you money and has sent you money in the past.
Enemies over
ban
there.
Him.
Might still be the
a scumbag.
The bats. Look at this.
Scumbags thing. And mental
a
cases
giant
on the internet
sword?
Still support me.
Surrounded by more swords.
And in another super chat by Turbo Pascal, last chance. I'm being a gentleman about it at the moment.
It's Dark Dave's fault.
He's being a fucking gentleman, you guys.
Humiliated, having tasted defeat by the state of
This is why people send money to DSP, so they can feel the power. They can feel the power. Because when you give him money, it obviously, that's all one thing that he wants. And you get that power, the PayPig power, the PayPig influence.
Hello.
And then when you threaten to pull the rug, let's see what's gonna happen. See what's gonna happen.
And now on his knees,
is he gonna ignore it?
Now, Turbo Pascal, you're threatening me, so why shouldn't I ban you right now and just continue to play?
Why shouldn't I ban you?
Because
he sent you over like $300.
Right?
Why shouldn't I ban you?
Give me one reason.
But the thing is, here's the massive issue, is that the PayPigs want a power trip, and DSP wants the power trip. While he is the guy with objectively less power in the situation, since he's the one who's on mission one and begging.
You're begging. Get a real fucking...
You're still on mission one.
Since he's that guy... But he wants to power trip on them and threaten to ban them. And they want to power trip on him and threaten to stop sending him money. So then you get like a tug of war of people that are all in wheelchairs. And it's really confusing and it's kind of sad to watch.
Threatening me, thinking that you're some kind of a badass on my stream to try to ruin my second Elden Ring stream. That I should even...
He's trying to ruin the stream. Meanwhile, he had like 10 minutes of downtime before that. Trying to troubleshoot shit.
What is that? What the heck? What the hell was that? That was an enemy?
Is there more Turbo Pascal or he's gone?
What the
or
fuck?
Is he banned?
Yo, a goat went into a Blanca ball.
Kill, and that's it. Because you're just going to
waste
our time.
What was that?
Oh, that's cool.
And I don't think there's more.
Stevie J, I appreciate it.
Yeah, there's no more. But somebody sent him $25, which is amazing. Let's go back to Snort Burnell. And DSP working more than full time.
No, I'm not a...
Only Sucker works a 9-to-5 job.
And that's 6 days a week. I get to spend one day a week with my wife. All right? No, I'm not a bachelor. I don't have 100% of my life to free time. Enough is enough with these idiots who say dumb shit things like, you should just make more time in your life to dedicate to what you're doing.
You have
for
the
living.
Same amount of time that fucking LeBron James has. And I've said this a thousand times in the past. You have the same hours in a day as fucking Elon Musk. Come on, you don't have, no, because you forget. What you forget is that there is actually people that watch you and have seen you. They don't definitely like you, but they've watched you, they've seen you, they know about you. And they actually work full time. They actually do. They don't just say they do, they claim they do and try and fucking justify it or some nonsense. They actually do. And they can see that this guy is just sitting there and bitching more than actual people who work more than full time. And even outside of this, he factually does not make does not work more than full-time hours. He doesn't work more than 40 hours a week of actually doing what he is paid to do, which is his fucking gaming shit.
How to learn this software.
How to learn this software. He doesn't even have editing software. The guy that wants to make his YouTube channel go up.
Fuck off. No, really.
Fuck off.
Fuck off.
No,
do
really.
Do it yourself. Go ahead and you...
Do it... What does do it yourself mean? I am doing it myself, as you can see.
Learn it for yourself and do it.
Learn it for yourself and do it. What does that mean? What? Just because I want Phil to have a stream that doesn't look like it's 15 years old, then that means I should have a stream that doesn't look 15 years old, which I guess, there you go. So I can criticize him, I guess, because I know how to do this. And I can edit videos and all the shit. And I make thumbnails that make fun of him. So I can criticize him, I guess, since I've done it already. So, I guess, does that mean I win? I don't know.
I have a life.
No,
I
don't have a life. I forgot about it.
Time to be doing this stuff. Every moment that I dedicate to do something else, I'm not streaming. But you guys want to see me streaming as much as possible. You complain that I'm not even playing enough of the new games, right? So enough is enough. I'm just going to completely write off these fucking idiots who say dumb shit like that. How dumb can you be? If I was someone who's one of these streamers who streams 3 times a week, a few hours a day, and has 1 million views and was rich and shit, and then they go, oh, I don't have any animations. Why don't you learn how to do it yourself? You only stream a few times a week. Dude, I'm here six...
But they don't say this. No, they don't say this. They don't say this. Why? Because they buy the stuff. They buy it. That's it. It's all for sale. You can buy it and you can put it on your stream for free. You can do that through Stream Elements. You can do it through Streamlabs. You can do it externally from some random site. You can do it from a YouTuber that gives away stuff for free. You can do it in 1,000 ways. The problem why people criticize you for this shit is because you have no curiosity and no proactive behavior, no actual interest in improving your shit. Unless somebody gives it to you for free and they give you absolute detailed and minimal effort guidance on how to implement it in your fucking stream.
Fucking days a week, more than full-time hours. I don't have time to become an animator on top of being a fucking streamer. Shut the fuck up.
Oh my god, he's drinking gin. Gin is great.
Gin, he's
That's
no longer drinking gin, by the way.
And it frustrates me when people are so dumb.
It's not criticism. You don't decide what's criticism.
That they think that
that's not criticism.
I mean, like, I'm some guy who just sits on his ass all fucking day and has time to do everything myself.
Yeah, you literally do. Factually, you do. And you have time to do it. You just don't know how. Just don't know how. Because if you knew how, then it wouldn't take you a lot of time to do it because you would know how to do it. All you have to do is just, you know, do it.
I would like to say,
you
guys,
could literally take this tips goal, this that we see on the screen right now, 77, and use $25 from it to buy like a layout from the Stream Elements store that would be animated and it would look like interesting at least. Yeah, it would be like a template, but still it's something. It's something. It's anything.
Thank you. You were
other than his fucking dry ass stream.
Pretty damn good for a late
and
night.
What he got yesterday was validation. In a negative reinforcement, because he sat there for 2 hours and something before even playing the actual game and got over $200. So congratulations, you taught DSP that sitting there meandering and fucking around results in a lot of money. Well, now he's gonna be expecting it. Good fucking job.
Stream, and I appreciate that. We had a good conversation. Thank you for chilling.
Had a good conversation. Great. About what? Great. About tips, Show cheers, stream. Subs, bits?
For the entirety of...
Donated the PC.
We hit the tier 2 tips goal. Hold on a sec. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen. May
what
I
do we get now?
You?
Oh, you know what we get.
The world premiere.
Yeah, this is the Elden Ring recap.
First appearance
Snored
ever.
Burnell.
Oh.
It's very nice.
Get ready. Get ready. I'm almost ready. Get ready. Here we go. Real
Yay.
Life Dumas.
Real life dumbass.
Yes. Real life Dumas. I am real.
Oh, it's terrible.
Dumbass.
I look so stupid.
This shit costs $15, by the way.
For the first
This shit is fucking terrible. It's a crocheted hat that costs $15 on Amazon. Couldn't even buy fucking Angry Joe. Angry Joe buys actual, like, cosplay outfits and shit. Well, they're not super detailed and, like, super expensive, but it's something. It's a prop. It's a prop. And this is some bullshit fucking hat. It's so lame. So lame. For the hypest stream ever. And this is what his fans also did yesterday. They encouraged behavior like this, where he's gonna pull out, he's gonna bust out all his tricks, like the singing and the shitty sarcasm and the clown mode layout and all that nonsense. He's gonna bust out all these moves every time when he expects money, and then he's gonna be disappointed if he doesn't get it. Big ups, Blanket Dival, for the €2 super chat. I hate that short act laugh of his so much. Yeah, this they're really
in over 10
the
years.
the short and the snake hissing laugh and the gold laughs, they're really bad.
I've come to the real world to take on the forces of evil.
Okay. Now look for chat for validation.
Yes.
Look at those LOLs.
I know it looks awful. I know it does. That's the point. It looks terrible.
That's the point. It's supposed to be bad.
A true Dumas who's about to
things
fight.
Things that are intentionally bad are always fun, you guys. Haven't you watched the first 15 Sharknado movies? They're intentionally bad. They're so funny because they're bad on purpose.
Forces of evil must have the proper equipment. All right? You need to have something to defend your
knowledge. He's literally beating his fucking head. What, you want to burp again?
Yeah. All right? And there's going to be a lot of shit thrown at me. So I got to be ready to tackle.
Knocking on his head. It's empty. Come on. What are you looking for?
Be deflected properly. All right? I scoured the internet for several minutes to find this hat and get it just in anticipation of this playthrough.
Dead.
Now, if it gets really bad...
That was a great fucking clip. It got to literally just the DSP, the end of DSP. This is the bad ending, by the way. This is when he just, when it's all finished on camera. That's it. DSP in 20 years, this is what it's going to be. This is how it's gonna end. Not with a bang, but with a whimper. And it's
now,
gonna be
really bad.
I'm gonna be restreaming it. I'm gonna have like 6 kids at that point and be like, I don't know, a massive restreamer. Because DSP is gonna be massive at that point in his career. He's gonna have hundreds of millions of people watching him. I'm gonna have half of that. And when he does this pose, I'm going to play the Burnell Productions audio, and that's going to be it. That's going to be all.
Burnell?
Hello, Burnell, and that's going to stop. And then somebody in chat's going to ask me where that sound is from, and then I have to tell them. You know, remember DSP's first bankruptcy, like, 40 years ago? Before all the 7 ones that followed? Well, it was from there.
I can actually put down my defensive guard, okay? This is very useful.
That's supposed to go on your mouth, dummy.
Because it protects me from any attacks from the eyes.
Yes.
The problem is, I can't see shit. So it would be pretty ineffective in a fight if you protect your face, but you can't fucking see anything.
Oh, this guy's lost.
Okay,
yeah. Let me look at chat. You guys love this.
The knight has his full armor set equipped and is ready for combat. Real-life Dumas.
Yeah, the bald spots are going to be much bigger in the future.
Now, admittedly, I got to tell you something.
Much bigger.
It's actually warm today.
He's actually going to be, instead of having like bald spots on his hair, he's going to have hair on his bald spots. He's going to be like, oh, you guys, I have like 3 new hairs. We have a record level of hairs on my head right now.
Because the sun is out in full force beating on my office wall.
Yeah, this pathetic fucking guy. He dresses himself like this, and then he's like, oh, I'm too hot in this fucking outfit.
It's actually quite hot in here and stuffy. If I get like completely sweaty and disgusting, I might have to
real life dumbass.
Wow.
All right, Elden Ring gameplay begins. This is like 15 hours into my stream. Actually, 4 hours. I think.
Damage,
3 hours.
You know,
I don't know. But it's like 2 hours into his stream. Yeah, and this is what he did most of the stream. A very interactive stream. Oh no. Such a miserable premiere stream. So bad. It was worse than the Donda 2 live stream. It was literally worse.
Yeah, fucked up. I definitely beat him. Oh, what a dick, he did a body splasher. Man, I was still feeling. The feeling is slow. Oh, I tried to dodge. Wow, he had 3 big combo that time. Is that power 4 now?
It's So we skip through this because this is just gameplay. I don't think there's anything else left in this video. It's just gameplay and dying. So if you're in for dying, you can go and watch him die a lot.
Boss is very challenging for early game. It's totally optional to beat him now. I know. Focus on finding three sides. No, stop it. I want to beat the boss. Can you relax? No, really. Guys, it's a new game. It's exciting. It's challenging. I'm having fun trying to beat this boss. Can we fucking relax and let me beat him? If you haven't noticed, I'm getting closer and closer.
Can you guys relax? Bro, have you forgot that you rely on those people for your paycheck? And they're telling you to do something else, and this is boring. And you're going to tell them, relax? You're bitches or whatever you call them. They're pussies. Because they don't want to fight this one boss. Not they don't want to fight it. They don't want Phil to fight it for the next 2 hours. And they're like, DSP, you are ass. And this is boring. And we've been sitting here for a long time. And there's also like 1,000 people watching. You should probably do something fun. No, you guys are fucking pussies. Shut up.
I'm playing the game for two straight days, not longer. I'm playing the game pretty much nonstop for like a month. Why do I have to rush? Why do you want me to rush through the fucking game?
Rush through the game? How do you even rush through the game?
Oh, there it is! Oh my god, I don't know how to dodge it yet. So much health. Right now, this is the one thing that's beating me, is this new attack. That he jumps and floats and lands awkwardly and does insane damage.
And some more deaths. This is what happened after calling people pussies. And then he beat him. Of course he beat him.
Told you I would beat him?
I told you I would beat him, dude. And he got 255 on the first stream. That's a lot of positivity. But still, yesterday, I predicted over 300. So he didn't even do that. So he is actually way more washed up than I thought he was. Now, since I'm desperate for content, I basically, this is all of the shit that fucking happened yesterday. I'm desperate for content, so let's watch something else. I don't know. Let's watch the one with fucking Skyrim. Oh, no, this one. I want to watch this one with Horizon Forbidden West. And, only two major supporters. And, of course, 1 Minute Man is there because he clocks in for his daily $25. So DSP doesn't look like a complete bum. Just a little bit like a bomb.
Probably a big fight.
Not a complete one.
Entrance to this cauldron slash holy cave.
Just mostly like a bomb.
All right, guys. So, great progress today, right? I mean, pretty much almost all story, except for that one side quest with the Huntress from the first game. Outside of that, that was pretty much solid 3 hours of story development, which was good, obviously. I had a great time. And I would like to say thank you to everyone who was here live. Now, here's a few things that I have to say, okay? For those who are here live, you definitely notice something. Those watching on demand, you have no idea.
What?
For some reason, this game is not catching on viewership.
Oh my god.
The graphics.
Yeah, they don't have an idea because they're not supposed to give a fuck. And now, look at this. First thing he's gonna say is the graphics are great. This game is not catching up. The graphics are fucking great. Jesus fuck.
They're outstanding. The plot is good. The gameplay elements are getting better. The only thing I would say is the platforming is a little wonky. That's a little annoying. But outside of that, the game is quite good. And I'm liking it. It's getting better the more we're playing today. I just bought.
Yeah, we can watch some vintage Phil. I'm open for whatever.
You know, like I like.
He's gonna sit here and chill for a little bit.
I definitely understand why a lot of people like it. I don't know why it's not catching on with my viewership. Absolutely no one's been.
But it's like, bro, this is a discussion that at most I could see somebody have with their mods, right? Because mods are to some extent like engaged with a fucking streamer, if they're like a full-time guy, I guess. Or actually I don't think we should have this discussion at all of who is supporting, why they're supporting, why this game is slow, why the whatever. The fans don't care about this. They watch the gameplay, right? And now there is no gameplay. There's just a bonfire just sitting there. And he's telling you that the game is not catching on.
Besides, some people apparently just think this kind of game is boring. All right?
Some There's nothing people, I can do yeah. about
it. I can't make
Some
this
people
game.
Think that fucking Elden Ring is boring when you play the same guy.
Landscapers are outside.
Oh, yeah, I'm definitely going to continue yesterday's video about the fucking leaks because he called them fake. Or based on a nugget of truth, which I'm struggling to figure out what the nugget of truth in that is.
I can't make this game more exciting. Okay.
I can't pick from all the truthful things that were in those leaks. I can't pick which ones are the most truthful for that to be the nugget of truth. Is it the champions stuff? Is it the PayPal transaction? Is he buying weed on PayPal and just like sending somebody weed money over PayPal?
or is just mobile games? Is that the nugget of truth? Hey, you guys, I was actually buying a lemon haze from Jonathan in my neighborhood, but I have to pay him through PayPal. Nobody does fucking actual cash anymore.
I think it's good. I'm having a really good time with it, and it's staying in my rotation, okay? It's not going anywhere.
Now, okay, I'm going to go back to talking about this when we actually watch the video, so let's just get this over with.
Looking like, geez,
oh, geez, yeah. Why would I look at this? Why would I look at Phil's fucking views unless I'm making fun of him? Why? I thought this was not my job, right? You have this whole big PSA about warning that you are just here to have fun and whatever. It's my job to look at attendance. Then why would I be looking at attendance and thinking, man, Phil is being super boring today. I wonder if it's the game or just Phil being super boring.
So low. This is like a night stream or even worse than a night stream. You know, I don't know. I can't explain it. I think the game is great. So I can't, you know what I mean? I can't make people attend a game that they're not liking, and no one really is giving a justification for it. I think the game
is quite
good.
Boardroom segment. Nobody's giving a justification. Big ups, Devin, for the sub.
Thank you to those who supported the stream. If it weren't for two people who supported with tips in a big way, yeah, it would have actually been a really slow stream too. But I appreciate that there are people showing up and supporting these streams. Thank you for that.
I appreciate it, but it was only two guys that gave me a lot of money. I wish they gave me more.
There's stuff going on my streams. That you don't have to be watching this constantly. It's not going to be constant.
This bro, he's acting like he's in like a, I don't know, he's driving a bus, and the people on the bus, they all want to get somewhere, but as he's driving, he's looking back and like being like, oh, you guys, I know this is boring, you don't want to stop in Boise, Idaho, but we're gonna get to, like, I don't know, Vegas soon. Like, what? DSP, those people can just close the tab and watch something else. You don't have to explain yourself, just play the game. And the people that care and that are interested in watching you play that game, they will stay, and the other people will leave, but you don't have to think about the people that leave, because you have people that stay. That if you don't think about them and think about the people that leave instead, they're gonna leave. Okay?
Now, if you're watching the videos on demand on ESP Gaming,
I don't know, just stop the bus. I'm getting off.
Watching, if you could give the videos a like and give it a like. Comment and say, hey, I like the playthrough. This will help.
Oh, I forgot to look at his fucking comments for Elden Ring, but whatever.
Like
it's just going to be approved comments. This should be a new phrase, approved comments. And it's what is going to be the romance cat guy who's going to say either romance cat or wow. He's going to get like 30 likes for no reason. Then there's going to be a bunch of people saying, Phil, I like this game. This is like probably the best game you can play. You and your mentality as a streamer and the design of Elden Ring as a game, it's like a perfect match. You're gonna be like the best guy on YouTube. And then Phil's gonna like that comment and be like, thank you, I knew it. I was doing something right.
And we'll actually maybe come and watch the videos and streams. I don't know. You know, I can only do my best. And people who are here
can do your best. Apparently, your best is not playing the fucking game.
The game, you know.
Is this your best?
I don't know. I don't know what to tell you, but I like it, and I'm going to keep going with it. I'm very excited to play this again tomorrow. I thought today was a really great stream, and I'm looking forward to more development tomorrow, okay? So thank you guys very much for a great session. Until tomorrow, peace out, and thank you. Awesome. All right.
Yeah, definitely so delayed support and approved comments. That's going to be the new DSP dictionary entries. Approved comments and delayed support. That's a super chat, is delayed support. Thank you for your delayed support.
Going to upload.
Because when you say it literally in the term itself, it implies that it's not better than tips. It's worse than tips. So when you hear this marketing speech, thanks for the delayed support, you're gonna consider tipping more, right? But then you gotta make a sock account on PayPal and lie about your information and then link a bank account or whatever. I don't know. It's way too much.
To the channel.
Way too much just to give money for a guy who is barely playing a game.
We can get caught up on the plot, because tomorrow we're heading right into more plot, okay? Tonight, Skyrim
plot.
After Dark, 6:45 p.m. Pacific Time. I hope you'll join me for 2 hours of Skyrim fun as we head towards Solitude, and when we arrive there, we continue with the Thieves Guild fun, okay? Tomorrow,
the
we'll
Thieves
Guild the Forbidden West. And
fuck this, DSP. Fuck this clip. What actually really impresses me about DSP is how consistently he manages to sneak in buzzwords into his sentences. It's just like, it's literally brainwashing. Oh, we're gonna go to Skyrim, to Solitude for some fun, chill, interactive Skyrim fun, chill interaction and fun enjoyment, like enjoyment. The opposite, in fact. It's just he sneaks all this in. Now, yesterday, we started this shit about the trolls and how he could have savings if the trolls didn't troll, but then they trolled. And then he got trolled, and then they robbed him because he had to give like $1,000 to some lawyer. And it's not a big deal, but it's a massive deal. And he's still trying to go back to where he was. So this could be any video from, I don't know, 2017 to now. And you probably, if you were a super blind man, you wouldn't even tell. You wouldn't be able to fucking tell. And we're halfway through this video, so if you want to see the first part, go watch the stream from yesterday.
Our best customer.
Fun. For we fun, interactive fun, Skyrim fun, chill fun, fun Skyrim.
It was Rissad's idea to come here now, while the land is in turmoil, where others saw only danger.
He's leaning in somebody in chat. You can see how concentrated he is on that.
Okay.
fun, interactive fun, chill. Elden Ring.
And by the way, I'm just going to say something
fun,
right
fun
now.
Fun, interaction, chill.
Really stupid conversation in the chat. Please don't be gullible idiots.
Don't be gullible
right
idiots.
Don't believe the shit that people put out on the internet.
Why?
It's not true.
What is the proof? Like, how are you going to actually prove it? Hey, big ups, X Mortis. What's up? How's it going? How are you going to... Why wouldn't I just believe? Based on you just telling me don't believe. When I can go on Kiwi Farms and look at videos of a guy talking to a robot lady who is surprisingly accurate about your financials. How does she know that? That sounds like science to me. They're having talking robots and shit. And you're just sitting there being like, don't trust anybody. Come on, just believe me. You love me.
Last year about me, and when I did consult legal counsel, the legal counsel was basically like, the best thing you can do, don't address it at all. Just ignore it.
Because you're bad at addressing stuff.
Speculation. There's no evidence of anything. Everyone can say whatever they want about you, but as long as, you know, it's not true, it's fine. Just don't bother with fucking with it, because every time you open your mouth, it's just going to end up being bad. And I was like, you're right. You're absolutely right.
What? The phenomenal lawyer told him, shut your fucking mouth. Every time you open your mouth, it's going to end up fucking bad. You're an idiot. Shut the fuck up. Don't talk about it. You dipshit.
Especially in a situation
but did you tell the lawyer about all the fucking money that is actually not about your business, but it's about your own pleasure in playing mobile games? But you write it off as a business expense. How does all of this line up in front of the lawyer guy? Or maybe that's some semantic that you forgot to mention. It's a business expense, dude. I play games. This is a game. Therefore, this is an expense for games. Sounds fucking good.
Like this? When
I agree with everything
that happened, and people took advantage of that to go even further with it on the internet and make up a whole bunch of lies,
like what?
A whole bunch of half truths about me.
Like what?
It's fucked up.
But that's what, he doesn't even want to name drop the lies and the half truths. Come on, we need a DSP Kiwi Farms stream where he just goes on Kiwi Farms, browses the main thread, and just debunks everything. There's some guy saying that Cat had a fucking abortion. It never happened. We actually have a son. Phil Jr., he's like 4 years old.
Narrative that they created, because they for years had been trying to push a negative narrative about me.
A negative narrative. You don't need to try to push a negative narrative. It just simply exists. You just choose to take it and twist it as a positive narrative. And then people don't trust you. Wow, fucking nice.
Now is our chance to spring on it.
Now is our chance.
But the truth is, there's no way that I would get any positive benefit by ever addressing it, which is why I never have, and I'm not going to.
There's, by the way, this really funny thread. I forgot how it was called. It's on Kiwi Farms about planning operations against Phil. Like when he was away in Connecticut to get married secretly, people were talking about infiltrating the household and taking Jasper hostage and kidnapping him for ransom. And shit like that. It was very, very serious. You should take it all really seriously, because it's for real.
I need to address all the stuff people said about me. There's no point.
What's up, Rick Sanchez?
It's all bullshit.
It's all bullshit. How is it all bullshit? You just said it's half-truths. How is it all bullshit? How is it all bullshit when there is parts of it that are based on truth? What does all bullshit mean? The 1651s, all the hundreds of
tens of thousands potentially of dollars on suspicious PayPal payments after he has explained to us in the past, in those old videos like Ask the King and whatever, it's a Mr. Cut Stuff video. He's explained to us in the past how this exact PayPal iTunes scheme works. He has told you in the past how it works. He told you. He was asking his relatives for PayPal iTunes gift cards for Christmas and shit. He told this. He said it himself. And then his bank fucking details leak. And then you figure out, wow, there's a bunch of suspicious and very large contributions to PayPal. Just like out of nowhere. And then the next day he is late on a payment for his mortgage. Wow. How is this all bullshit? All of it is bullshit. It's all imaginary stuff that is kind of factual and it very much makes sense. Well, those people should write a fucking book. Some science fiction shit. Since it's maybe, so bullshit, like I said, but it's so convincing at the same time.
A lot of it maybe ended up based on a nugget of truth here.
And by the way, look, when he addresses it, at a late chill stream of Skyrim, where the least people are gonna see it, obviously, of course, the trolls are gonna fucking clip this, because that's what they do. But he was trying to sneak it away from as many people as possible. This could have been a little bit more sneaky, only if it was an unrecorded segment.
Or a nugget of truth there, but it's all bullshit. There was never any data dumps or leaks that were ever accurate. It's all lies. And I just, there's nothing I can do to stop people from-
It's all lies.
Shit up about me. There what? There's so much shit made up about me on the internet.
Is he gonna talk about the escort, right? He's gonna talk about that because that is factually bullshit. That anybody can tell you that shit is factually bullshit because trolls exposed it. It was trolls that exposed it. So everybody knows that's bullshit, and that's what he's going to give us an example.
Based on a little twist of truth here.
A twist of truth. What does that even mean?
It would be like taking a single hair that's real and putting it into a fucking fake toupee, but there's one piece of hair that's real. You say, oh, well, that's a toupee.
That is absolutely no. No, what? That you spend hundreds of dollars a month on fucking alcohol? That's a nugget of truth. No, I only spend $90 a month. Do you spend all that money on DoorDash when it literally says so? Like, the fucking leaks, they can't be more factual than this. Outside of somebody literally going to Seattle and going in this guy's house and taking his phone and making a complete uncut recording of everything to record his actual bank transactions on anything. This is how the only way it could get more factual than this. All that shit is true. All of it is true. It doesn't matter if he spent the money on WWE champions, which 100% it was, because you do the numbers, and his ranking in the game, and his stats, and the players that he has, and all that shit, it only makes sense if you spend a ton of money on that.
Wait, but the entire thing's fake, except for, doesn't matter. The one hair that's real in there means the whole thing's real, right? That's how these people treat it. So,
like what?
That's all I'm gonna say. Like,
okay, give an example.
Oh, did you know there were leaks of Wallfield's information last year? No, there wasn't.
Yeah, there was. Yeah, what? What? What?
No, there wasn't.
No, there wasn't.
On the internet is fucking false.
How? How? If you can say how it was false because it's your information after all, you can just say how it was false. How is it false?
So I don't wanna.
Because there is way more actual evidence proving that it's actually true. Nobody spent money from his account or none of that shit. They just saw the fucking transactions and it all made sense. It all made sense. All of it. Literally all of it.
Have that narrative be pushed around. People are believing that shit.
The fucking salty tweets in the middle of the night, they made sense because he fucking drinks all the time late at night to cope with, I don't know, being lame as fuck, I guess. The fucking spending on DoorDash makes sense because he can't get fucking DoorDash out of his mouth. He talks about it all the time. He talks about fucking eating breakfast and getting breakfast burritos ordered to him and all that shit. The WWE Champions makes complete sense because the transactions, the 1651 is a loot box plus tax. That's what it means. A loot box plus tax. Everything makes sense. Everything. Not having money constantly makes sense because he spends it all on fucking alcohol and champions in the middle of the night. It all makes sense. It literally all makes sense.
It was always false, but I'm not going to sit here.
It was always false. Time. How? Just say how.
Through it all and telling you.
Oh, well, yeah, I'm not going to waste my time.
True, but all this is fake.
Yeah. People are claiming literally you spend the tips money that go to bills. You spend them on fucking microtransactions. But I'm not going to sit here and tell you how that's not true. I'll just say it's not true and hope you believe me.
There's no point. It's bullshit. Don't believe the bullshit that all right. pieces of shit on the internet push out there.
Shout out to pieces of shit. Personal
gain or to continue to push their dramatic...
Personal gain. Yes, I gain personally so much from this. By the way, I'm going to get a raise at work from shitting on Phil and saying that the leaks are true. Yeah, my boss is like, dude, you better fucking stick to that narrative.
It's all bullshit.
It's all bullshit.
My fucking life that gets ruined when these people make this shit up, but I'm not going to choose to entertain.
You ruin your own life. If you weren't hiding all this shit and being absolutely, like, really easy to tell that you're bullshitting everybody, then people wouldn't do anything about you. They wouldn't do anything against you. They wouldn't just, because, no.
Okay.
No.
Yes, MC2 Tech Reviews, you really should fucking stop because you're the one that said it, and it's wrong.
Yeah.
It's wrong. Okay.
Hey, MC2 Tech Reviews is in my chat, too. Why are you saying false things, dude?
Shout out. Oh,
what? Stop spreading misinformation on the internet.
I wasn't even there before. There's an email shortcut. Because my laptop updated. Now there's new shortcuts.
What is happening?
Shout out to Rebel, who did a $10 super chat and says, loving the
updated is fucking
I've
shit.
Turned from the detractor to being a supporter of you. I'm proud of you, Big Phil. Can I still reach out your email? Yeah. Anyone could always email me, Darkside Phil.
Yeah, except he doesn't respond.
I'm going to respond.
Yeah.
I do my best to try to read up and if
give them some more prestige. Oh, they sent me a business email. I'm not even gonna respond. They're not even worth my fucking time.
Solid response that I can give you. I'll do my best, but I get a ridiculous amount of emails. Okay. Alright, so thank you, Rebel, for that super chat. Alright. Looks like we're finally arriving at Solitude here.
Fucking nice. And there's more of this rant.
Yes, I know, Carlos. See, and here's
what do you know?
Example. Carlos says, isn't it crazy that people believe these conspiracy theories after that whopper that you had some kind of an escort you were flying all around?
No.
What was happening?
Bruh. That shit, the trolls proved that to be fucking false. Literally the trolls. The people that are supposed to lie. They're supposed to lie, and they proved that that thing was bullshit when it was in their benefit. To actually believe that it wasn't bullshit, that it was real. Because the trolls would have a field day thinking that DSP got an escort coming in the fucking country from Europe. And him having a micro penis or whatever. That would have been hilarious. But they were interested enough to prove that it was bullshit. Those people that lie all the time. It's the same people. Literally the same individuals. That lie all the time. Prove this shit to be bullshit so Phil could have an easier life. And not be extorted by fucking scammers.
In that case, here you go. The nugget of truth that turns into...
Do I have caps on?
And then
actually, no, not right now.
You know, the truth comes out. I
can't handle all the caps, man. Too many crowns.
Girlfriend, Kat, and we were having times when we were spending time together. And I would tell you guys, oh, I'm spending time with someone, you know, or whatever. I'm taking time away from streaming or whatever to do that. And people literally made up a giant story about escorts and things that literally was completely 100%.
People made it up.
The truth was, that's fucking nice. Was I seeing someone?
Yes. There's nothing that makes me trust a guy more than him talking in abstract generalities. Oh, there was some people that made this shit about me, about this and this and this. It's all bullshit.
Was that taking away from
I trust him so much.
Yes, that was true. Was it an escort who I was flying around the world and paying? No. That's what I mean. Like, people made shit up. There's the one hair of truth. Yes, I was seeing someone. I was keeping it on the down low. But yes, I was seeing someone. And, you know.
Yeah, big ups for subscribing, Rick Sanchez. If your subs were public, it would pop up, man. We would have a moment.
Inside this giant fake.
It'd be so cool.
Of fake hairs and say, now the whole thing is real. See, there's escorts and there's brownies and there's trips.
Brownies?
And there's this and that. And it was all bullshit.
Yeah, I don't know all that lore. Because it's literally false. Like, why would I know that lore that is bullshit?
Times over the
that is just made up shit. I went to Phil because his penis was small. And, yeah, I made love to Phil, and then I went back to Europe. Now I want a $1 million from Phil.
done this to me. Okay.
I don't know why she had the Phil voice, because she's fake, bro. She's fake as fuck.
Me too. I can't wait to see Elden Ring. I hope.
Because Andrew, for the mature adult membership, spam those emotes, dude. Go bust. A mature adult army.
And Mr. Oh, excuse me.
Better than the hate army.
$5. Said I haven't tipped in a while, but I love the channel. I've been watching you since your old Street Fighter 4 videos.
They're more mature. Jackson. I absolutely and have their emotions in control, not like the hate army who just can't get not hate.
Good to have you back here tonight, and thank you for the support. Appreciate that. Cool. Thank you.
Thanks.
No,
you're
but
welcome.
Think of it this way, guys. Hold on. Think of it this way. This is the truth. I would like nothing more than to be able to say debunk the shit that people say about.
Yeah, what? But you can.
Bottom line is every time
you literally can.
One of two things happens. Either I end up revealing more information.
Okay.
That you guys basically shouldn't know.
Oh yeah. So number one is he's dumb and he talks too much. He overshares.
And then these idiots.
Big ups, Buck Ray.
To try to hurt me even further. So in some cases, trying to defend myself actually hurts myself worse than saying nothing. Okay. Or they just move the goalpost anyway.
Move the goalpost. What, as in realize that you're hiding more stuff? Because he reveals stuff with the things he says also reveal things that he's been hiding.
Actually does get explained logically. Oh, that's not what you're saying it is. Here's what it really was. Okay. What happens? Oh, well, what about these other 14, 15 things we made up? Well, wait.
He reads fucking Kiwi Farms too much. Because Kiwi Farms is like, look. You've all watched the fucking reality show, and Kiwi Farms is a gossip forum for the reality show, and they speculate on everything. Is Kat pregnant? Is she leaving? Is she actually a man? Is she actually two people? Is she having a triplet or something? It's just like, they talk about everything. And big ups to Rick Sanchez for the public sub. Now you had your moment.
Things up about me for a decade.
Big ups.
So what do you want me to do? Just sit here and talk about it for the next 4 months and never do any meaningful content? No. Fuck you. I'm going to sit here and enjoy games. So
enjoy games. We talked about this for half an hour. This is half an hour of actually doing it while saying he's not going to do it, but he's wasting his time. He could have just simply debunked it. Just open up your phone. Show me the champions. But he's going to try and, because that's how it's going to happen. If he tries to debunk the champions, he's going to try and log out of the account, make a new account. Then people are going to look it up and see, oh, this account was made literally yesterday. And then they're going to call him out and he's going to say, look, I proved that the mobile game fucking bullshit was bullshit. And these scumbags are moving the goalpost again. They're saying, oh, you made the account yesterday. No, look at what they're doing. I fucking proved it here. And he's going to show like a blurry phone to the camera. Just like when he showed a piece of paper that said bills on it and he shaked it in front of a camera and was like, look, this is where my money goes to.
Okay.
Fucking nice.
You see?
Okay.
So many details to work out.
All right, you go work out those details. Get the fuck out of here. I think she's part of the quest lines in here in Solitude. Sambuca just hit me $6.66 and says the following. This is meant to be constructive. You need more tip animations, and it would be good to have
make them.
Automated stuff. I think this was more important with Twitch, maybe also here. You should keep.
Why would you have unabandoned stuff when you can waste your time writing people's names on a leaderboard? Because he's allegedly hiding from trolls, but people already know he's being trolled. That's the thing he's most famous for, is for being trolled.
Reinventing yourself and keeping it fresh online.
Reinventing himself? When the fuck did that happen?
Reinventing myself, it was actually really nice on Twitch to be able to do new stuff with some of the features that were added constantly. For example,
like what, penny points?
Channel points?
Yeah, penny points.
We had special streams that were like, oh, Phil does these challenges, right? Can he do this? Can he do that? And people would wager their channel points on it. Sadly, we lost that. You know, basically
sadly.
When I went from Twitch to YouTube,
because of not hateful slurs,
doing, and I really enjoyed doing on
people
Twitch,
lied.
I wish YouTube would do something equivalent. They claim they're going to, like, no lie, YouTube outright said.
Is he for real? He paused the game to talk about gifted memberships.
In 2022, we're going to add a ton of functionality that our competitors have.
It's literally February.
So that this could be
literally
a experience. I would love to do new stuff like that. I can't. My hands are tied because YouTube doesn't have
hands
those
are tied.
Things. I don't know.
You can
why.
Do stuff outside of YouTube. You can do Patreon stuff if you care so much about shit like that. You legitimately can. With the Stream Elements bot, you can have channel points. You can have channel giveaways for points. and things like that. You could have that. Of course, it's not directly linked to you getting money, so you don't care.
It won't.
And also takes some effort to set up.
Implement them. What's taking them so long?
What's taking them
I
so
really
long?
I have no idea.
Developing software takes long because they have to make sure it works. Otherwise, you might spend money on something and not get the benefits, in which case you can sue them and probably get a lot of money because they scammed you.
Now,
and YouTube, they don't want to do that. They would rather make sure it kind of works first.
As for new animations, I love getting new animations. If you haven't noticed, we've had some new animations for Christmas. Then we just had one since I started Skyrim.
We had one, by the way. No, you should say somebody made me these animations. No, we didn't have them.
New animations. We had Skyrim ones back in January.
They materialized.
It would be great to get some animations for the new games out, right? For Horizon,
it should be great.
For Elden Ring that I'll be playing for many weeks now.
And it's like the saddest thing is that his fans, they spend the effort that it takes, and I'm not going to be criticizing them on how much time did you spend making this shit for Phil, because I think that's a shit argument. But they spend the effort, and I think the mindset of wanting to kind of, I don't know, do something for somebody that they're a fan of, you know, and make them happy. And I don't think DSP actually appreciates this. He takes the shit, the animations, all that garbage, he uses it, and it's like, oh, we have a new thing. But he feels, based on what I've seen from him getting stuff in the past, he feels like you doing something for him is actually, he's doing you a favor, because you get to do something for him. Because he's that guy, he is Dark Side Phil, he's a celebrity. And if he uses your stuff, your animation, your intro, your graphics, whatever, your frame or whatever, if he uses those, then it's like a lot of people are going to see it. He's giving you so much exposure. And he's carrying this attitude back from literally back in the day when people used to give him PCs and games and all that shit. They just send him shit for free. He's like, oh, I got this. This is a shout out to you, man. You got to give me something. And I used it. Fucking
but
nice.
I don't have the means.
Okay, you can. You have the memes though. You're a living meme. I don't have the talent. This is nice, by the way. He managed to sneak in, I don't have the talent, which congratulations, Phil. You said something right. You don't have any talent.
I you know what I mean?
And it doesn't necessarily take talent. You don't have to literally buy Adobe After Effects and start making up some animations or some like pop-ups and stuff. You don't have to do that. You have to just kind of look up on Google what is available, and then you can just buy some presets or just, I don't know, hire somebody to do it. I don't know. Just do the shit that other people do. How do thousands of streamers do this? And Phil can't. But he has to have a segment when he asks people to do stuff for him. I don't know how all this works.
My success.
Crowdfunded guy.
Strongly dependent.
Why are you wearing this as a badge of honor? Crowdfunded guy. Just call yourself a fucking hobo.
On you guys.
Crowdfunded fucking guy.
Supporting everything.
It's like when EA said that loot boxes were surprise mechanics. Yeah, this guy's a crowdfunded guy just because he completely depends on random people on the internet being generous enough to give him money. And that's a badge of honor because he's real. He could have sold out even though nobody wants to sponsor him or pay him to do anything or collaborate with him or give him a shout out on Twitter or give him a shout out on their own stream unless it's sarcastic or they literally call him an asshole. Yeah, that guy. But yeah, please don't sell out. Be real.
If someone
Be
wants
real.
To make animations, great. I'm open to accepting them. You guys have seen I got a pre-roll for my Skyrim stream, Skyrim After Dark. I got this cool,
yeah, that's a troll. That's a troll. Why do you still use that? That's a troll. It has a Booker T lurking and stalking. That's literally a troll thing.
A border here for the camera for when
Booker T, because he said the N-word live on air back in the day in WWF. And the lurking and stalking is from my memes. And there's a bunch of other memes. There's like lean in manual bands and shit like that. Getting cocked again.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
I play Skyrim. We got all this stuff that's new. And I'm doing my best to refresh things when I can, but I don't have the know-how or the means to do this stuff. I don't.
Rip.
You know what I mean?
Why are you doing this for a job then?
Do it yourself. How?
How?
How the fuck do I just learn
I don't know,
how to
Google.
Do it and magically do it? I can't.
Look up, I don't know, Twitch streamer, Twitch streamer animations, okay? This is like the most basic thing a human being can Google. Like, actually, there's a bunch of videos that say free animated Twitch overlays, and they help you how to set up with Stream Elements, which is, by the way, what DSP uses. There's here some stuff, animation for streamers at Fiverr. Fiverr, you could literally hire somebody to do this for you, starting at $4.66 to make this stuff. Let's actually put this in browser view, since now the CPU is doing okay. We have this. This is Fiverr. We get everything for like $5. Very nice. There's some that starts at 93, but of course that's some more stuff. That's like an actual graphics package. And then there's people who ask, how do you animate Twitch streams? How do you get an alert? How do you do this? How do you that? There's Pinterest for ideas of stuff. Look at all this stuff. Wow, this exists. This is on the internet. The same place DSP makes a living on, by the way. Very fucking nice. And unlike most of the people that use these overlays, DSP is actually making a full-time hours living. Of course, here you get Upwork, which is another freelance site where people can actually do stuff for you, and they have their own portfolios. So yeah, there is plenty of ways you can do this. There's hundreds of ways you can do this, and a lot of it is free. But the Seattle hobo, he doesn't want any of that. You should make it for him. Send it to him in a format that is as easy as possible to implement. And if something doesn't work, you gotta fix it. And if he doesn't like something, you gotta do revisions until he likes it. Because you are doing him a favor. Because you will know deep inside that Dark Side Phil, the king and god of an emperor of streaming, you will know that he likes your work. He enjoys it. To put it on his quality product.
For it. I literally just explained to you my financial situation. I don't have extra money for anything. So I can't pay for this
stuff. No extra money for anything.
You see?
No extra money for anything. What is extra money? The money you spend on suspicious PayPal transactions to iTunes? That is the spare money. Spend it for your business. I don't know.
Okay.
It's probably a bad idea, though.
All right. You know what? I'm tired of this now. All right? I really am. Stop it with the nonstop people who just always demanding that. Phil, no, really. You should just drop everything you're doing and learn how to make animations and do it all yourself. I work 6 days a week over full-time hours. I work more in the days that I stream than
Baller
if I had
alert.
A 9-to-5
Baller
job.
Alert.
And that's 6 days a week. I get to spend 1 day a week with my wife. I'm not a bachelor. I don't have 100% of my life to free time. Enough is enough with these idiots who say dumb shit things like, you should just make more time in your life to dedicate to what you're doing for a living. Why aren't you studying how to learn this software? Do animation.
I already talked about this yesterday or earlier, whatever. So you already know.
No,
about
really,
this.
I mean it. Fuck off. Do it yourself. Go
the
ahead and you learn
cap.
It for yourself and do it. I have a life. I have a full-time job. I don't have fucking.
I have a life. What do you do? What do you do? You don't seem to have a lot to talk about. You talk about burgers and being stuck in traffic because you didn't know it was President's Day. That's what you talk about. And you talk about your dumb wife, how she fucked up her breakfast again. And she put sour cream on a French toast. So you had to throw it out because you're actually cavemen and can't even figure out how to eat burgers and toast and shit. That's all he does. I have a full-time fucking life.
Time.
Tell me about it.
To be doing this stuff. Every moment that I dedicate to do something else, I'm not streaming. But you guys want to see me streaming as much as possible. You complain.
You guys complain.
Enough of the new games, right?
You guys.
So enough is enough. I'm just going to completely write off these fucking idiots who say dumb shit like that. How dumb can you be? If I was
they're being dumb.
One of these streamers who streams 3 times a week. A few
hours. No, I don't know who these streamers are.
A day and has 1 million views and was rich and shit. And then they could, I don't have any.
How do they have the 1 million views? How? If I was one of those streamers that, where do they get millions of views? I want to go to that store, the views shop. I want to get it. I want to look up how to get millions of views. They must be getting millions of views for doing something, but no, people are watching them because they're already popular. Well, when DSP was already popular in 2014, why did people stop watching him? And now he gets 300 views per video. Unless it's literally the biggest game of the year when he gets 1,000 views and then it drowns down to like 300. fucking nice, man. Maybe you should be more like those streamers, since, you know, people enjoy them.
Animation.
What? And they don't have to rant about this for 30 minutes about their personal life and the drama that trolls caused because they don't like him.
Why don't you learn how to do it yourself? You only stream a few times a week. Dude, I'm here 6 fucking days a week.
Nobody asks you to be 6 days a fucking week.
To become an
animator. If you ask certain people in his chat, they would say he should be there 8 days a week. He should be there 20 hours a day.
On top of being a fucking streamer. Shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up. He works over full time. Massive baby. This is how devoid he is of any fucking actual brain activity. Anything that would keep him in reality. He's completely devoid of reality. So far away. That's oh my god, criticism. I work that's so fucking hard. And that's not criticism, of course. Nothing is criticism.
It frustrates me when people are so dumb that they think that that's the situation I'm in. Like, I'm some guy who just sits on his ass all fucking day and has time to do everything myself. Right.
Yeah, Rick Sanchez, if I had a million subs and views, I probably couldn't manage to read chat. So that's kind of the thing that comes with the territory. Of course, he hates on those people that have a chat that is active because people are having fun and talking about stuff. He hates them because he believes that the actual true pure streaming is when you're in sub-only mode and people can't talk in your chat. And there's like 5 people that are the same people every day that talk in your chat. And you respond to their questions about burgers and sandwiches and your sink being clogged or whatever. That's the true interactive experience. Those people, they're not interactive streamers because they simply can't manage to read chat. Simply.
You don't notice there's more idiots spamming in the chat. I just ignore the nonsense. Yeah. It's so dumb.
And somehow the guy who's the true, pure interactive streamer still has idiots that are spamming his chat.
Damn, the athlete
I don't know how it all fucking works. Let's see some, I was actually curious about some Hate Army Watch classics. I want to see which are the most popular videos here, and maybe we can look at them. Because it's just some vintage feel. Some vintage relaxation. We're not going to do the Russia-Ukraine shit, because he possibly cannot tell us a single thing that would actually make it worth watching. So we're not going to do any of that instead. And watch DSP's terrible fucking takes on a tragic world event. DSP loses his mind in epic pre-stream. I love this. This is from when Snowcarl died. Welcome to this segment of the stream. This is the vintage, quote-unquote. It's the Kate Army Watch segment where we watch the most popular clips. This is almost an hour long. And it's from when Snowcarl got banned. So let's enjoy. And it was the one where he pulled out the bills and was like, look, this is where my money goes to every day. It says bills.
So that's the plan. But then all of a sudden I start noticing this week, the last couple days, number one, everyone's kind of being negative on the stream, saying, oh, Phil's just playing these old games. Phil's playing games that are horror-themed and Halloween ended. And we really wish that he would have went out and bought Metroid Dread and Guardians of the Galaxy, and that's what he was playing this week.
Eventually, he did play both of those. Games to the stream, yeah, he was bitching for no reason. Eventually, he played them. He cried during Guardians of the Galaxy. Wow, these are great in retrospect, because I get to actually look back in hindsight whether or not this rant was justified in any way or it was just bullshit. Spoilers, it's just bullshit.
I would have allowed new eyes on the stream, people who've been waiting for these games,
get new eyes on the stream,
and it would have basically
not super blind men, by the way.
Okay. That's basically what people were saying the last couple of days. And then admittedly, on top of that, the last 2 days support on my streams has been slow as hell.
Slow as frick.
I'm streaming 2 hours,
slowest stream ever.
I haven't even hit the Gunner Glasses goal yet. Some days we barely do. The night streams have been really slow. Last night I made $30 playing House of Ashes, which is crazy because the attendance was good. The actual attendance of the stream was pretty decent for a late night stream of a game I've already beaten once. But
very nice. Still, have been pretty the slow, attendance segment.
Just being honest, okay? So here's what I'm noticing, and I'm like, well, this is not good. Because allow me to now elaborate a little bit on what's been going on with me these last few weeks and how it's affected me and what I wanted to do on streams and how basically I haven't really had the flexibility to do what I want, okay? October was not a great month. I talked about it all
October.
All
right, the October segment.
Man,
oh no.
This year is the polar opposite of how October usually goes. Usually, here's how the year goes.
How does it go, Phil?
Summer's pretty decent, and then all of a sudden in October, things really ramp up because a ton of new games come out back to back to back. Usually, they're high-profile, AAA, giant-hyped games. This brings in more people to my content and my streams to watch these hyped games. In turn, this brings in more contributions, more ad revenue because there's more views on my content. In general, October is the first of three giant months where things go whoop for me with content creation. I don't know how it works.
Of course, it's Broktober.
I would assume it's kind of the same for anyone who does video game stuff. But this year was actually the opposite. The actual opposite.
Oh, no.
This year... October.
Now we get to look back on October last year. Then, if I gotta talk about my own shit, then it was when I was having my big hype after the leaks, man. I made that fucking video that I really did not like, but it helped me out a lot. So big ups for everybody that came from that video. And DSP, it was very slow because he was hoping for November for the GTA games to fix everything and for him to play... Metroid that he played way after the fact, and to play Guardians of the Galaxy that he played way after the fact, and so on. So it was kind of downtime because he was lame as fuck and was playing some shitty games nobody asked for.
Down from September.
I think.
Why? I'll tell you exactly why. Because there was nothing going on in October. Alan Wake Remastered. Super Monkey Ball Collection.
Super Monkey Ball. That shit was ass. That was ass to watch him play that. Begging plus just terrible gameplay. The game was really shit to watch him play. The commentary was bad. He was putting it on a chill stream, so I couldn't watch it or restream it because it was way too fucking late for me and way too boring. The highlights were bad, the lowlights were bad, everything was bad. Terrible.
Right? Far Cry 6, the
Far Cry 6, absolute snooze fest. Another Ubisoft asset flip Far Cry game, this time with more cute animals, so it bumps up the review scores from people that don't care about games and just care about looking at virtual cute animals and talking about how cute they are and how one of them has a wheelchair and it makes it so special and interesting. Watching DSP play it was a snooze fest as well, complete boredom. I don't even remember if there was begging, if there was any drama. It was just like going through the motions video gaming in the modern era. By a guy who looks kind of melted.
It's almost exactly the same game, and everyone panned the game in reviews.
Oh, but he thought it was great. That was the narrative with that. They panned the game in the reviews, but he played it, and there was the DSP narrative of, but dude, this, I don't even know why people are making fun of this game. First of all, the graphics are great. The story is, like, really good. It has the guy from Breaking Bad. From the Los Polos Hermanos guy that he blew them up. You know what I mean? And I don't know why people are making fun of this game, man. It's like really good. But support has kind of slowed down, so I'm going to go and tweet something out, and hopefully it's going to pick up again.
Even though, personally, I'm really liking the game, and I think it's chill fun, it's hard to bring eyes to a stream when everyone out there slammed the game saying it's too similar to the previous games and it's not fun. I disagree, but it is what it is. The stigma is already out there, right?
The stigma.
Lost Judgment? No, I didn't expect that we were going to get giant amount of eyes on my streams for Lost Judgment. We didn't have it for Yakuza. We didn't have it for the original Judgment, so that's not a shock, okay? House of Ashes, for 2 days...
That was lame as fuck.
Great.
House of Ashes. I mean, it's one of those games that is just him sitting there and pressing X and then failing to press X and dying.
And of course... That you're going to have returns. You're not going to have people who are here for the entirety of the second playthrough. Supporting the second playthrough the way they did the first playthrough. This is all natural stuff. But the point I'm making here, okay? The point I'm making here is that October this year had zero, and I mean it, zero AAA high-profile hyped releases. The two games that I skipped in October...
High-profile releases. Dread, this is Elden Ring right
game.
Now.
That game was
the super-profile release.
The early 2000s, that is an old-school Metroid game. Every time I play Metroidvania-style games on my streams, they fail. Low viewership, low support, low everything, and everyone's...
Metroid Dread was on the fucking hit list. It was hosted.
That's a game that I could play later.
A rip.
There's other cool stuff going on in games, I'll balance it with that so that it's not me playing it and everyone complaining that it's boring. You see?
They still were. Even though he got some tips from some PayPigs, so it was all right.
Admittedly, that's a game that I missed out on.
Yeah, rip Joker, man.
It was completely misrepresented.
Too close to the sun, dude.
All the previews and everything they put out for it. The game looked bad.
Come on.
Like, it really looked terrible.
If you're going to pull up with memes in my chat, at least be funny. This is...
Oh, my God, this game is really outstanding.
It's kind of wheelchair.
That one, admittedly, that's a miss for me. I absolutely would have played it on launch day if I had known it was going to be good. But all the evidence we had said it wasn't going to be good. And then it comes out and it's great. I'm like, okay, well, that's definitely one that I want to play then, okay? Now, that was October. Now we're in November.
If you want to troll in chat and be funny, I'm going to let it go. But just know, like, the same worn out memes.
Broke, basically.
I get it. Oh, look, okay. He's broke. But hold on. Hold on.
In October.
Never mind. Fuck it.
At the end of the month,
never mind.
With over $1,500.
Just be funny, okay?
Bill, for shit that I
had. Oh, he was robbed. This is that stream.
To try to clean up.
It was that stream
by someone who committed identity theft with me and screwed up all my financials. I had things that were fucked up to the point where I had multiple things that weren't paid, fees on top of fees, saying I'm in default and stuff, which I should not have been. But all my shit was
No. Come on, dude. You were getting like a late payment fee and some penalties, was getting fucking penalties, and then the next day he would spend like $100 on DoorDash. It was so fucking funny to look at those spreadsheets.
So it got frozen.
It's literally like video game money. It's like in video game money. You spend all you got on gear and equipment and consumables. And then you just wait for more. You can't save up anymore for the later levels.
And it took me a while to figure shit out.
It was so fucking funny.
I had to pay a ton of money to get stuff fixed and get back on track, which thankfully
that's never happening
now. But it costs money. I actually
back on track. What track is he on? The slow track.
Because you become
the special track.
And you have to pay money to fix your own shit. Like, I was the victim of a federal crime, but now I'm set back tons of money.
Yeah, they should have found the guy, but they didn't, right?
And I have no defense against it. Okay, now I'm just gonna tell you guys this right
actual
now.
Actual criminal.
I'm not gonna put up with any more fucking slander and defamation and bullshit.
What are you gonna do? He still hasn't done anything to this day, from 11th of March. Actually, no, that's me reading it in European language. From November 3rd, 2021, until now, nothing happened. It's just, I'm putting my foot down. I'm not going to take any more of this. This is stopping right now. And then nothing happens.
These scumbags who say, oh,
scumbag.
You're all bad identity. You don't have to spend any money to do anything. Fuck you and your mother. Really. Fuck you and your mother. Because you're a piece of shit.
Bruh.
I'm the one who's going through it right now. I'm the one who's going to have a bad time trying to pay back all this fucking money I owe now for all the shit I had to go through.
Oh, Phil doesn't have to spend any money.
I know what I fucking owe because I have the bill in front of me, and you're not going to sit here on the internet and lie about it because you're a scumbag who just wants to fucking contradict
you fucking
everything
scumbag.
I say to try to make me look bad. Fuck you.
Trying to make me look bad. The guy who spends thousands of dollars on mobile games and then turns around, sits on this chair and asks for tips. That same fucking guy who perpetually has no money to exist. So if he skips one day of streaming, he physically can't exist anymore because he has bills clearing every day. He's like a massive company.
You don't know shit.
You don't know shit.
You don't. You're not.
Apparently, you don't know shit too because you can't even fucking manage your money with $5,000 a month spent on your business. Somehow doesn't have money for video games. Somehow doesn't have money to pay his basic bills.
Here in my shoes.
After a bankruptcy. It's not even before a bankruptcy yet.
Who's putting up with this shit every day. I'm tired of the slander and defamation against me and everyone saying I'm a liar. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
You don't know anything. You're
this is hilarious. This is hilarious. And he's giving you the reaction and the rant as if secretly behind the scenes, the mafia was extorting him for money. And he owed the money, and that's where all the money went to. But no, instead it went on to a fucking mobile game, microtransaction, Candy Crush fucking nonsense. That's where all the money went.
Fucking basement with no responsibility for yourself Or you're some lucky snowflake who's been protected from real life and doesn't actually...
Of course, we have to be like Phil, a lucky snowflake that his parents paid for all his fucking universities, and he was kicked out of all the jobs he had, including the one that his dad got him through nepotism. And he was kicked out of that. And he is so shit at having a job that even the own job that he made himself in his own company and his own business, he has to literally ask people every day for money to be fucking, to still exist as a business. Very fucking nice. Or the other extreme is if you're literally in the basement meme, you're the in your mommy's basement, whatever guy with no job, with no bills, with no responsibilities, whatever. Which DSP kind of seems to kind of be like that too.
Yeah, the
no, he has an office. It's not the basement, you guys. Come on.
When someone fucks with your livelihood every single fucking day, like they do with mine. Okay?
Why are you being trolled? Why aren't other people being trolled?
I am in a bad situation now because of the crimes that happened against me. It's that simple.
The crimes against humanity.
Now, I had to pay a big chunk of those legal fees at the end of October, because if I didn't, I was going to get slapped.
It was basically a hate crime because haters did it.
Ridiculous.
They hate them.
Interest and late fees and stuff.
Hello, is this the FBI? I've been subject to a hate crime from a concerted group of fucking Cuban pieces of shit on the internet. They hate me.
On top of the fact that for a month, all my shit was fucked up because I had no money because of the identity theft. Now I have these fees that I have to pay, and if I don't pay the legal fees, now again I get slapped with interest and shit. Okay?
Oh, that was wet. That was wet.
On top of that, there's other shit going on too. Like, I actually told you guys the other day. So, I do this awesome Halloween marathon, right? The Halloween marathon is just outstanding. We have a ton of fun together with it. One of the best ones I've done, I feel, because the games were outstanding, the best episode of Feasting with the King we've ever done. The support was good. I made over $300 in tips.
And he bounced back like he's fucking Big Sean.
I literally end the marathon.
Oh, phenomenal.
I go downstairs.
And then
and
what?
The vacuum cleaner is sitting in the middle.
Oh, yeah. This is the cat being a caveman accident. The vacuum cleaner accident.
And I say, cat, what's wrong? Oh, the vacuum cleaner broke. What? Yeah, the motor must have gone because there was smoke and everything, and it won't turn on now. And I'm like,
wow, literal aliens.
Aliens. Seriously? Like,
this is the guy that brags about accidentally saving money.
Hey, you guys, I didn't actually spend this money. You're never gonna fucking guess what happened.
You know? I'm like, wow, I just had a really long, fun, but very draining day entertaining my audience.
A long, fun, draining day.
That stream to buy a new vacuum cleaner.
Yeah, well, that's what it goes to. That's, you know? That's why it exists, right? That money exists to support you, and buying a new vacuum cleaner is a part of it.
But this is what I mean.
Would have been kind of cringe if you took that money and didn't buy a new vacuum cleaner and just bought a bunch of microtransactions instead, which you probably also did.
Like, this shit just never lets up.
Since this business not doing very well.
Frustrating for me now. You know, it's just like, it never ends, man.
Never ends.
It never fucking ends. It never ends. It's just endless. One thing happens, another thing happens, another thing happens, and they just keep piling up, and I can't take care of them. I just don't have the flexibility financially like I used to. There was a time when, oh, something like that happens, pull out your credit card. I don't have a credit card. Oh, something like that happens, go to your
savings. The first thing, and this is not just this time. I'm mentioning it because it has happened so much in the past. The first thing. When it comes down to needing money, the first thing he always thinks about is, man, do I have a credit card? That's the first thing he thinks about. The first thing, always, when something like this happens. Oh, man, I wish I had a fucking credit card.
Savings. I don't have...
And the second thing he goes to is savings. I don't have savings. You don't... Yeah. Because you spend all the money on bullshit. Okay.
You know? I don't have any.
Because the same guy that both buys a bunch of groceries and buys a bunch of DoorDash. That is actual cooked food that they give him.
You know, this sucks. This really, seriously sucks.
And also drinks and also microtransactions.
And by the way, that's not everything. That's the main stuff that happens.
It's not everything.
I wasn't expecting to get a $1,500 fucking legal bill at the end of October. I was expecting to get maybe a few hundred dollars. And I was like, oh, that'll be no problem. Then in addition to that, in October, there's other stuff that happens every quarter. Like, I had to pay my quarterly state business and occupation tax. And that's a giant chunk of money that has to go. And basically, by the end of October, I'm broke. I have no money.
Okay? And Broke-tober strikes.
Here I am. I'm in a situation.
Broke-tober comes back, and everything's right. done.
And I'm in a situation
where Broke-tober.
We're heading into November. People want to see new games. I don't have money.
$5,000 monthly go to the expenses of his business. And he knows this because he goes specifically and counts up all his expenses for his taxes to write them specifically off the business stuff. And it all amounts to $5,000. But he doesn't even have money to buy video games. The thing that is the only thing that you should have money, if anything, to buy video games. Otherwise, the business is done. There's no business. No, I can't even buy games anymore. How am I supposed to trust you? How am I supposed to have a long-term trust if I was a pay pig to invest money in you, hoping that you get better? How am I supposed to do that? When you have money for, you gradually have less money after you got a bankruptcy approved. How?
Streams is going towards bills. In fact, this is actually what I wanted to show you this
week. Oh, okay. We go for the meme. We're going for the massive meme. You know, I love memes.
This is what I really want.
I'm a meme lord.
All right.
Yeah, this is what I really wanted to show you. A piece of paper that has bills on it.
Out there, they say, oh, Phil gets a giant payment from YouTube every month, man. He's just lying constantly and making shit up about money and everything. Here's my list of financial responsibilities every month.
So? Okay, I don't trust you as a person. I believe you are untrustworthy. Why would I believe a piece of paper that you wrote down? This is not a piece of paper that was printed from somebody sending him an invoice for, I don't know, spending or something. If he was an actual business, he could show us an invoice. It's not a fucking PayPal invoice. It's just a piece of paper that DSP wrote bills on it. I could pull out a piece of paper that says I have millions of dollars. Would you trust me? Here are my fucking bills. Look at them. Not even showing it to the camera. We don't get to see what it says. It just says bills. Just says bills. And some of them are actually written out at this point. Apparently, he's actually paid them.
I write it out by hand. I probably should type it out. But
yeah,
write
why
it
would
out
you do that?
Every month.
We don't get to see anything anyways. Look at this. This is garbage. It's garbage. And I can put it on the highest quality, which is 1080, which is still going to be unreadable completely.
Giant checklist of every bill that I owe.
Okay.
Right? And it's commonplace stuff.
Like
it's
what?
My internet. Here, I'll read it to you. Here.
You don't have to read out basic bills. I know you spend money on internet and water and electricity.
My internet, my condo dues, the electric bill, the garbage
the
bill for the
bill.
Garbage guys that take the garbage away, other utilities,
pay my taxes,
like gas and
pay my
water
back
stuff,
taxes,
my
pay
cell
my utilities,
bill,
pay my mortgage, pay my internet
my
bill,
insurance
pay my
payment,
utilities,
my car payment, the mortgage on this house, the back
what
tax payment
clown.
That I owe to the feds every
okay,
year.
Okay, yeah, we know about all of this. Do you know why? Because we've seen your fucking bankruptcy fucking papers. The shit that leaked literally the night before the actual bank leaks. That shit was actually his bankruptcy filings and his credit card filings and how much he owed for all the credit cards. We have such an astounding amount of info and actual data that there are people who are smart enough and dedicated enough to actually make sense of and tell us what actually happened. And you can actually go find it out. It's all surprisingly transparent from the guy who is not transparent about anything. They had to literally brute force transparency, and he's still full of shit.
My taxes properly for several
literally.
Years,
you get to see on a fucking literal factual information about how much he spent, and he's still going to bullshit you.
Afford it. The regular tax payment that I owe the government every single month because I own my own business and I have to pay them monthly for what I estimate I owe them in federal
okay.
income tax.
Okay.
My health insurance payment.
Okay.
Now I have to pay these legal fees every month that I'm breaking
all right.
up. In addition to other stuff. So for example, there's other,
what is other stuff
that I have to like kind of spread out payment.
What? Well, this is like a waste of time then. You're going to fucking pig-splain some random bills.
This is my life every month.
This is my life. It's just a messy piece of paper with bills written on it. Thank you for the fucking life explanation. I trust you now. I trust you. Now that I saw a blank piece of paper with some writing on it, I believe everything you say.
this giant
check. It's actually impressive that you did this.
List of stuff. And whenever money comes in, like the YouTube payment comes in roughly around the 21st, usually it's like between the 21st and 23rd of every month. The moment that money comes in, okay, the moment that money comes in, pay the mortgage, pay the taxes, pay the back taxes, pay the state taxes, pay the health insurance, pay the...
All right.
It's gone. My October payment
it's gone. Why do we hear about DoorDash all the time and going out to restaurants and knowing about all the restaurants in your area and knowing about all this shit? And also in real time, we have the ability to look at this guy's fucking WWE Champions account and see that it's growing. That shit is growing. So he's wailing on that shit. Because he's at a point where he can't make actual growth without spending money on the game. It's one of those games. And he's completely locked in the fucking cycle of being a pay pig.
From YouTube.
Very surprising. It was
immediately gone within like 4 days.
It's gone.
It was gone. It went to every bill.
Every bill.
Gone.
Maybe your bills are glitched. Maybe you don't count your bills properly. Maybe you just spend too much money on shit that is not bills. But we don't talk about that. And then everything is bills. Everything is bills. Because... somehow, probably DoorDash is also bills. I don't fucking know how he sneaks it in. I don't know, because he's lied once. He's gonna get the negative reinforcement to lie again on his taxes and write more shit on his taxes than it has to be, because he does that all the time. Because he realized he can do it, so he's gonna keep doing it. So I wonder how many more things are tax deductible and tax write-offs that he does that are in no way related to the streams. I wonder if Kat's PlayStation is a business expense because she's maybe an employee of Burnell Productions. Maybe some other stuff. All the DoorDash that he gets for feasting with the king, literally that is written off on taxes. That's how pathetic this guy is. A fucking burger for like $20 at most, the whole thing.
On top of that, all the tips that I had made went and paid the legal fee, went and paid the health insurance, had to pay for a new vacuum. You know what I mean? So, gone. And this is my life. And this is what frustrates me.
Well, your life is kind of sad.
A literal group of...
If you weren't that much of an asshole, I would probably feel a little bit sad.
Who sit here and defame me every day and make shit up. Phil's blowing his money on DoorDash. Phil's blowing his money on mobile games. Phil's blowing his money on this and that. No, this is where my fucking money goes to every month. All of these pre-established things that
This piece of paper that is in no way proof of anything. Would it be proof if I just pulled a piece of paper that it says DSP is lying on it? Would that be proof? That is equally proof.
That's where my money goes every fucking month. Every single time a dollar comes
such
in.
Such a trustworthy
right
guy.
All right? I'm not sitting here on a pile of money. Oh, what can I blow it on today? No, I'm nickel and diming my way through life right now.
Nickel and diming my way through life as I order breakfast and lunch and dinner from DoorDash, and I go and I buy a bunch of alcohol. And everybody can tell that I do that because I post angry tweets in the middle of the night, in the AM. Fucking nice. As if nobody knows what you do, DSP. What the fuck is this bullshit? He's the most predictable person on the internet.
I really am.
I really am, man.
As I've told you guys.
How do you even convince yourself? You gotta be really fucking stupid to convince yourself that all this shit is true. Well, this is literally your own life. He can't even be objective about his own life.
Earlier this year, Bruh. It wasn't like this. Earlier this year, I was in a better situation.
How? Oh, yeah, you didn't get kicked out of fucking Twitch.
I was making a good amount of money on Twitch.
Good amount of money. This is an arbitrary number amount of money. And then a good amount of money on YouTube.
Money with tips. Things were
oh, no, not even YouTube.
Oh, man. Things that kept going that way fucking for the whole tits. Year, I would actually be able to start saving money again. I would have a saving...
Again? When did you last save money? When? You've been day to day since 2014, 2015, 16. Probably. I don't know. 2017 for sure, because then it was just, you guys, I'm a true chill interactive streamer, give me your pure tips, nothing else helps. Everything else is delayed support.
His account, put money into
save money.
Have something. So, for example, if my shower breaks.
That literally happened, yeah. $1,000, by the way. It took $1,000 to fix a shower, because he had to hire a guy.
If the fucking vacuum breaks, I would have a savings to draw upon to pay for that stuff.
Or credit cards, but you can't have credit cards anymore.
Income to pay for it. I would have had that if Twitch didn't fucking screw me and kick me out of their partner program.
And now it's Twitch's fault.
Legal justification for it. They still to this day will not respond. They don't care. they feel like they have no legal responsibility to show that I did anything wrong for the fact that they kicked me out of their fucking partner program. The day they kicked me out, my income went from up here to here. And I'm trying.
Hey, Canagraphs, I fucking love this.
Up a little bit since I become a YouTube streamer. It's gone
this
up
is some bullshit.
More,
this is some bullshit.
And then all of a sudden in October, it went back down a little bit.
This is bullshit.
Which sucks. You know, I was on an upward trend every month. Oh, I'm getting a little bit better.
No, money? No.
So this is what I'm going through.
This is what people go through. Having to pay bills.
Okay? Seriously. This is what I'm going through.
I'm
in this situation. And I got people coming to stream.
What, saying Phil has a lot of money and he gets pissed off?
Yelling at me.
Yelling at me.
Why are you playing fucking Metroid Dread? When are you going to play Metroid
Dread? I don't have money for it.
When are you going to play Guardians? When are you going to spend more money?
When he plays Champions. Literally every night.
I don't have it.
I don't.
Okay? I don't. I don't fucking have it. I would have loved nothing better.
I have no money to do it. I have no money to do it. I have no money to do it.
Or Guardians or both.
Sounds good.
I don't have it. I'm sorry. You know, this sucks. I don't want to sit here and talk about this, but this is my life. I don't have it because of all these circumstances that keep fucking coming up and screwing me over every month.
I love my life.
Every time a dollar comes in, a dollar goes out.
I love my life.
And then something comes up, I don't have the money for it, so I got
to
draw.
What a life. A life to truly love.
You spend on anything. Tomorrow's my day off.
Money evaporates from this guy. Just vanishes.
Penny pinch.
Gonna have to penny pinch.
In order to afford.
Because he has this weird thing where he has to have a certain amount of money to spend on his day off. Otherwise, it simply doesn't work. You can't just do anything else.
What I do tomorrow, which is grocery shopping.
Can't just spend less on groceries.
Getting supplies for Jasper and other things for around the house that I can't just normally get at the grocery store. You know, it's going to be tight. It's going to be very tight to even just do my weekly stuff. And I haven't been out for 7 fucking days. And most of that money that I earned over the last week is gone. On top of that, the last 2 days, you know, it's been, like I said, it's been slow. Because do I expect people to come to every stream and be completely outpouring with support? No. You would hope that it could be a balance, but it just hasn't been a balance recently because of all this shit going on behind the scenes with me. It's screwing me over. It is. It's ridiculously screwing me over to the point where I just can't get it. I can't get back to square one anymore. You know what I'm saying? It's not that I don't want to play new games with you guys. I want to. I can't. Now it's like, because remember, before
my
it was, well,
God,
I'm in the middle of
such
the other
a
game.
Sad fucking existence.
So now you're like, okay, well, you finished the games. Why aren't you playing the new ones? I can't afford it, man. Like, right now. So here's the situation I'm in. This is me real talk. Right.
Mission
now,
one.
On.
Mission
tomorrow's
one.
My day off. I need money for my day off. I should be
It's
okay.
Not even mission one. If streaming is your job, this is like the tutorial. Because you should, by default, be able to have games for your business, right? It's not even mission one on being a streamer. It's not even mission one. It's the tutorial level. It's the character creator.
All right. I have no idea what I'm going to make today on streams at all. And every day it's different. I have no idea what I'm going to make on Visage and Lost Judgment today. It could be great. It could be terrible. I have no idea. Okay. Tomorrow is my day off. There goes a bunch of money. There's nothing I can do about it. I got to buy shit for the house. You know, it's my day off. When I come back this week, okay, over the weekend, I have to raise, no exaggeration, $800 over the weekend, because the middle of next week I have to pay my internet bills
and the electric condo bills. No,
$800.
Okay,
and I'm not gonna have
it's your fault. That's your fault. Why did you put yourself in a situation where you would have to pay all this fucking bullshit? You knew that streaming is not stable. Why are we even having this discussion? Excess money
this week to go towards that, you know. So in like 3-4 days, well, I guess 5 days, I have to oh, by the way,
it's literally video game
Wednesday
money.
Of next week is
it's
my
literally
day off. It's the only day off of the week that my wife and I can schedule together. I have to have money for that day too. So you see my predicament? In the next few days, I'm supposed to raise $800 plus money for my day off to pay everything. Oh, Phil, why don't you go buy Guardians of the Galaxy? Why aren't you buying Metroid Dread and playing? This is why.
What dipshit? You fucking idiot. Isn't playing the newer games that are hot, interesting, and people want to see and they ask you for, isn't that gonna reflect with more money for your business so you can buy more games and pay more bills? You can pay all the bills you want. He has like a bill fetish. Just fetish to pay bills all the time. when you play shit that people ask you to want to play and that just came out and that it's interesting to watch, you're gonna make more money. But I don't know if that even correlates to how shit works with DSP, because it's really weird.
I don't have the flex.
Sometimes he would beg massively and not hit $100. Sometimes he would not beg and hit like 150, or just beg a little bit or something. It's really random. I wouldn't understand it at this point even.
It's an ability I used to have anymore. I don't. There was a time when I was single. I lived in Connecticut. I had zero expenses besides the basic things. I didn't have
that shit. Was a great position. That was great. Why did you just jump into the deep end? He did the equivalent of having a shitty apartment and then moving in a mansion when all that you can afford is the mansion. You can't afford anything else. You can just buy the mansion and nothing else. So he's sitting in an empty mansion that has nothing in it and just being like, man, why did I fucking do that?
I didn't have this. I didn't have this. People fucking with my financials and my identity, costing me thousands of dollars to fucking fix and freeze.
Hey, what's up, Michael? Good morning.
In debt because now I've
like almost 3 p.m. here.
Because I couldn't pay on time, you know, like all this shit going on. None of that was like that back then. So I had flexibility to go out and in 1 week I could buy 5 fucking new games, 3 of which were terrible games. And I would rush through the games and beat them all and trade them in and buy 5 new games the next week and all of that. I just don't have that anymore. I wish I did. No, really, I wish I did.
Yeah, it was the biggest mistake ever to move to this house. It was so bad. Such a mistake. Terrible. Should have just rented some shitty apartment somewhere, even in fucking Seattle. Why not? Move to any fucking state you want. He could afford to do it. Rent a shitty apartment that is big enough for like 2 people and a cat. It shouldn't be that hard to find. Just something that is well within your means, so you can have plenty of money to just spend on bullshit. Because YouTubers like spending money on bullshit, that's understandable. But make sure that the bills are covered first, and not so you spend money on both bullshit and bills. And then left with, I don't know, confusing.
Someone just said to me yesterday, Phil, are you going to play Call of Duty Vanguard? No, I'm really not interested, and I played the beta and I thought it sucked. And someone said, well, what if someone buys it for you? Would you play it then? Yeah, if you're going to buy it for me, I'm not going to commit to playing it long term, but I'll at least play it a few sessions and see if it's any good. But I'm not going to drop my own money on it when I wasn't liking the beta. Immediately when I say that on the pre-stream, there's slanderous videos.
Phil slanderous videos.
Fans buy them for him. He won't spend any of his own money. See what I mean? See about him? What the
But the thing is that, of course, he sees people that watch it on YouTube as brainless idiots and just like actually people with no literal, no actual free will or free thought or independent thinking or being able to question stuff. Because if it's a clickbait fucking video and the video title says DSP, I don't know, fucking begs for tips, and you watch the video and he doesn't beg for tips and he doesn't even talk about it, you're gonna know it's clickbait and you might dislike it and might leave a comment saying, dude, this is fucking clickbait. Or you might just carry on with your day. Because his fucking opinion on viewers is just, he sees them as nothing outside of a number and somebody who could potentially give him a lot of money. Nothing. They don't have their own free will to think about and question what DSP is telling them. They should believe him instantly because, dude, it's me. I'm telling you this. Come on, why would I lie to you? I'm honest. No, people don't. People question your reality. You might believe you're honest to yourself, but you've put yourself in this position of not being trustworthy because you think in a very different way to other people, I guess.
Fuck. Yeah. How is it a negative? Say, I'm not going to spend money on a game that I played the beta of and I'm not enjoying.
That's not a negative.
How is that a negative? That's a fucking logical thing to do. If you tried out a game, you didn't.
And again, he's taking some random fucking video that somebody made about him. It's taking that video. Oh, fucking Phil's not gonna play the game.
Why buy it?
Why?
If someone's gonna buy it on my behalf,
I don't know,
because they're really desperate to see me try it, that's different. But why the fuck would I spend my hard-earned money on a game that I know sucks?
Hard-earned, right? By the way. Begging for fucking games and tips and members. Back,
because it's important. This is hard-earned. Literally everything I owe every month.
Let me put this. It's an official piece of paper. It's an official Burnell production document. Okay. This guy is so fucking silly. How serious he takes himself.
So, folks.
I'm not saying when you run a business, you shouldn't take yourself seriously. But if you take yourself really seriously, that will reflect on your behavior. You are gonna act seriously and not burp yourself like a baby and pound your chest until the burp comes out, or fucking snort into the microphone, right into the microphone, and do bottle crunches and all this fucking embarrassing shit. When you take yourself seriously, you're gonna put in more effort because you want other people to take you seriously, right? But no. He takes himself seriously only when it is supposed to make him look good. He's just talking the talk, and he doesn't want to walk the walk because his back hurts too much. And probably his shoes are uncomfortable, or he doesn't wear socks, or something else. He has gout flare up again.
The reason that I'm bringing this up is because when I see people coming on the streams and literally like slandering and defaming me and saying, oh, Phil just doesn't want to, he's missing opportunities because he should be playing the new games. I want to. I can't. Okay? I want to and I can't. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to pay my
bill. The narrative changes all the time. All the time. Sometimes playing the new games immediately is great. He would love to do it, but he's broke. Sometimes playing the new games fast sucks because all the shills do it. Sometimes playing the new games is just not good because people are playing it themselves. It's just always a different thing.
Next week. I don't know. It may be I have to not pay certain bills and then face late fees and issues and have to pay them after the fact. I don't know. And the fact that I've now had two consistently slow support days, streams where I've made like $20, $30 a stream, you know, that's, what am I supposed to do?
It's a slow chill.
Money on new games. Now, I talked about this on the previous
video. Can't do anything.
Okay.
Can't do anything.
And I'll
nothing.
Say it again.
He just expects the world from people as he delivers the absolute bare minimum that he has convinced himself is a massive amount of effort.
If
the bare minimum.
Someone is interested in helping me behind the scenes.
And help me behind the scenes. No. No.
If you want to donate some credits to PlayStation
Fuck,
Network,
man.
Or some credits to Xbox Live, or some credits to Nintendo. I mean, if you want to.
Oh, and now he can't break eye contact with the camera. Now he wants to convince you. Please, you guys, if you want to fucking subscribe, maybe behind the scenes. He can't break eye contact, but when he was bullshitting, he was looking all over the place.
Right? And of course, the Pokemon game that's
so bad.
Later this month, Nintendo Online.
Why does
he
keep doing this shit?
That would help me tremendously right now.
Please.
Really?
Please.
That would help me tremendously because it would give me flexibility to do whatever.
Please, it gives me flexibility.
Okay? If.
Now he's looking at chat if they're going to buy in. Enough of this. Who's getting banned? Who's getting message deleted? What did they say? DSP Gaming, I think we are all wondering why you don't get a second job and make streaming a part-time thing if things are this bad. The job market is hiring a lot right now because of all the COVID stuff. No, wrong. According to Phil, the job market is completely dead. He was thinking of getting a job. He was actually, the retcon story is that he was, I forgot the exact term that he used, but he was really hyped for getting a job. Actually, and then COVID started, and then you physically couldn't find the job because the jobs were all off. They had a slow day at work. So yeah,
flexibility to do whatever. In fact, I'll tell you this right now.
So yeah, okay. He can get a job now. This guy is gonna get banned. The other guy's gonna get banned, who is saying what did he say, some Bob guy,
right.
This dude is begging again, lol. This is getting
really?
Banned.
That would help me tremendously because it would give me flexibility to do whatever. In fact, I'll tell you this right now. Okay, if. Okay, enough of this. I'm not entertaining dumb questions.
Why can't we just cancel Phil already? Because you can't cancel a TV show that is not even on TV. He's like on some shitty cable station that nobody fucking watches. Barely. The outside of people that talk about it because it's a funny reality show. Or people that, I don't know. Stay up in the late at night and it just comes out on TV and you just watch it. Public access TV, yeah, that's true.
When I get dumb questions,
he's like a Scorch PFG TV. If you know who he is, you know who he is. If you don't, then you better not. It's nothing interesting.
Why don't you get a second job? Fuck off.
Yeah,
no,
public
really,
access TV.
Off.
He's in between the commercial slots for like, I don't know, dick pumps and some other sexual products and like Cialis and shit.
Phil, I don't understand, Phil.
cross his arms?
6 days a week, full time.
Who says this? Literally nobody said this.
6 days, full time.
Nobody cares how long you fucking stream. It's the quality that matters. You can make one video a year that's a lit fucking video, and everybody's gonna be okay to wait a year for the next one. But if you make shitty videos every day, nobody's standards are really gonna be that high. They're just gonna expect you to keep making shitty videos.
Why don't you get a second job? Fuck off. You're gone.
Fuck off. You're gone. No, really. Fuck off. Fuck you and your mother. I'm very convinced.
Anyway, so all this being said, yes, that would help tremendously. If I can tell you this right now, if I were to receive some gifted credits for, say, Xbox Live, or I guess PlayStation, it doesn't really matter. Although personally,
if I were to get this,
I've preferred...
That would be really nice, but I would personally prefer to get this one, you know what I mean?
Playing games recently on Xbox Live. I have.
It's,
I like
it's just preferred donation platform.
Xbox Series X, I like this controller.
I get surround man, sound. Fuck this.
So, that fuck. I would prefer if you were going to pick... Oh,
that's garbage.
I'd like to get filled credits of PSN versus Xbox Live. I would definitely
And he transitioned some, like a straw man from somebody telling you, Phil, you work 6 days, 7 days, 8 days a week for like 40 hours a day. Why can't you get a second job? No, fuck you. Send me credits. That was how it went.
Xbox Live. But
fuck
I'm not
you.
Gonna
send me credits.
Chooser here. I'm not going to look a gift horse in the mouth. If people want to gift me
should
some
look
stuff,
your wife in the
like
mouth.
Easily buy games over the next month and take some pressure off. That would help tremendously. Yes. Abso-freaking-lutely. And like I said, definitely with Nintendo Online. For Metroid
great
and for Pokemon
fucking segment.
Up, that's what I would definitely need for that. So I would say either PlayStation Network or Xbox Live credits or Nintendo Online credits. That would help me tremendously in November. Because then I would, okay.
Yeah, he's a choosing beggar. That's the thing. And not only is he a choosing beggar, that's why one of the reasons he's so interesting to people. Not only is he the beggar who chooses everything, he also completely denies the fact that he's a beggar to begin with. Because him being a beggar is like an established thing. It's like, you can't fucking dispute. DSP is an e-beggar. That's like where you start. That's the first thing you tell somebody as you explain who DSP is. Look, DSP, Darkside Phil, it's just a guy on the internet. He begs a lot and he's fucking toxic. But he doesn't even want to acknowledge that he is a beggar. Because he already convinced himself that he's delivering this amazing, great fucking product. This amazing stream, and he's working a lot. He's working thousands of hours a day, and all this grinding and all this shit, and he deserves the money. Not only he deserves the money he gets, he deserves way more than that. He deserves so much that he wants to hit $150 per stream, which is actually a massive amount of fucking money to be doing what he does. Because for some streamers, of course, they're famous for a reason. They might be doing fucking reaction videos or playing games or doing ASMR, but if they get 150, then it's probably more worth it than Phil, if I gotta be honest with you. It's probably more productive and interesting, entertaining content than DSP.
Got Forza on Game Pass, so I don't have to worry about that. And if I could cover the rest of the stuff for the rest of the month, I'm like, okay, now all my money that comes in, I can focus on the essentials, the bills I need to pay.
Yeah, not just 150 a stream, but two times a day. And admittedly, on a second stream that everybody knows it's not going to hit that goal because it's a night stream. And it's like, you know, it's the night shift.
And not worry about now I can't even afford games for the streams and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, well, that's not a very successful channel, is it?
So I hope that makes sense. Okay? I hope that makes sense.
It doesn't really make sense. It actually doesn't.
It's incredibly stressful.
But when people point out it doesn't make sense, you say, fuck you and your mother, go whatever yourself, and that's it. And you get banned.
And frustrating to me, when I'm literally trying to just scrape by to make ends meet right now, because of all the shit that's going on in my life, and I got people on the internet completely lying and slandering me, saying that, oh, Phil's lying.
He's slandering
he's talking
me.
About, he's making shit up. And then on top of that, I got people coming to my stream saying, oh, well, I'm not entertained by Visage. It's just another horror game. He should be playing Metroid Dread. Yeah, I don't have the fucking money for Metroid Dread. You know?
Well, too
I
bad.
Wish.
You should.
I fucking
that's
wish.
Too bad. It's like a fucking moving company that doesn't have money for a moving truck. And it's like, yeah, I can move your couch, but we're gonna tie it up to the horse. Like, what? No. Get a fucking truck. But we can't afford a truck. We just paid all our taxes and all our bills. Can't afford to get a truck,
man. Are there
man.
Certain games
it's
we can buy
assholes.
For you or you decide what it goes to? says, Nealter, you can't buy games for me because they don't do that anymore.
Yeah, they don't do that.
Oh, I bought it.
But if you send him $60 and you say, spend this money on Elden Ring, and he's going to say, you see, this is just a charitable contribution. You can't really say what I'm going to spend it on, and I'm going to spend it on my bills. I have to, you know.
Digital code, and I sent you the code and it downloaded.
Yeah, that's the guy.
He did away with that. Now it's just the credits. You could buy codes that you redeem for credits on these networks. It sucks. I used to actually like that when people could send me a code. Oh, now you own the game. In fact, I remember the last four, so that's exactly what happened. Someone sent me a code. I put it in. It gave me the full game and the season pass and everything. I was like, oh, that's cool. You can't even do that anymore. Now it's all just tied generically to the credits, I guess. That's it. So, yeah. You know, but if you know what I'm going to buy. If you give me Nintendo Network credits, I'll buy Metroid Dread and I'll buy Pokemon for the month. If you give me Xbox credits, I'll buy Guardians of the Galaxy. I'll pay for GTA Collection. And then what else is coming up this month? Battlefield, right? So I'll pay for Battlefield with that. You know, that's what it's going to go to. If you give me PlayStation credits, I mean, I'll be honest here. Probably I'll get Guardians with it. I don't know if I want to get GTA Trilogy on the PlayStation 5. Because, number one, I really
GTA
like
Talk, I miss this.
Number two, I'll get surround sound. Now, then again, you know, Rockstar hasn't actually come out and said...
Hey, it's super crazy out with that only iced coffee interview. Yeah, I should take a look at this when it comes out. I'm interested in what the guy is going to say.
Sound in the Grand Theft Auto trilogy.
Even though I'm not going to trust any of it, but it's something.
Have they? What they said is remastered visuals. They said that. They didn't say anything about the audio. And those games do not have surround sound.
Fucking audio.
So I'm wondering if that
Big ups
to
old school gamer.
Yeah, maybe it actually wouldn't at all, right?
For enjoying these consistent streams. I would just, because today I was going to just play Cyberpunk for like 16 to 20 to 30 hours straight. And then I was like, let's just do a stream. Let's talk about yesterday. It was great. It's fucking nice. And also it's chill. Because I have the soulmate is doing errands and stuff for her business. So I'm just kind of sitting here and chilling.
Okay.
Okay. Let's right. scan
anyway,
chat.
Guys.
Snipe chat.
Oh, Zen Shuriken says, what if someone says use this for Call of Duty? Then I would do that. Like someone right now, if someone...
Yeah? What about Untitled Goose Game? They sent him... Who was it? I fucking forgot. It wasn't PW Dubs. It was some other guy. Fuck it. Untitled Goose Game. He gave him money for that and then he didn't buy it.
Phil, I really want to see you play Call of Duty on Friday.
Yeah,
what do you
no.
do if I send you this code?
No.
Yes. I'll play Call of Duty on Friday. I'll probably just do
DJ
one.
Runo. Yeah, that's the one, David.
Worth playing. I'll probably
DJ Runo. DJ Refund.
Yeah, if that's what people wanted. Yeah.
That's absolutely. How I know I'm DJ Refund.
But again, the other thing, the caveat of that, don't just send me stuff and be like, oh, now use it for a game that we're not even talking about. Like, oh, I'm going to send you a code and play fucking Shin Megami Tensei. No, I didn't say I'm playing it. I mean, I'm not going to now take these weird criteria. Now you're going to force me to play games on my streams that
Let's
I'm not
for a day.
Playing now because you think you're just going to send me.
Play it for a day. $60 is a lot of money. $60 is a lot of money. I know it's just simply the tier one goal plus $10, but it's a lot of money for normal people that give money for streamers. That's a lot of money to people that just give money to a guy who is doing shit for free.
Definitely not doing that. Has to be a game that we're talking about and that we're interested in doing and everything this month, okay?
All right, another choosing beggar. But Phil, I'm going to literally send you the money. Why don't you play it?
This is what I've tried to...
Just play it for like 2 hours.
And people, I guess, have
been... They'd be like, whoa, this is my first impressions. He could do that, like a first impression night stream. That's a fucking scam. If somebody donates money and says this is for this game, you just get it. And you please the guy, you play it for like 2 hours a night or once a week. You can do those first impression streams and then you can upload the clips of your actual impressions on YouTube as a separate video. Wow, there's so much fucking there's so much potential for scamming there.
Easily forgotten
and cheesing.
So I want
to. But he's too dumb. He can't do the work to do that because everything has to be according to a weird schedule where some imaginary people are going to complain if he doesn't stick exactly to the weird schedule that he makes himself and decides what it's going to be.
All right.
Someone in chat's going to be like, Phil, you should play this other game today. And he should be like, okay. There's people in fucking chat that, you know, you can't please everyone. You can only please most of the people all of the time or all of the people most of the time. You can't please everyone all the time.
With bigger power comes greater responsibility. So I have to, you know, manage my stream.
The reason that the tips goals are what they are, all right? $50, $100, $150. Remember, the tips goals used to only be $100 per stream when I was on Twitch.
Literal dollars.
The reason I had to up those tips goals is to try to make up for the lost revenue that I had since I moved from Twitch to YouTube. I used to have 900 subs on Twitch. I used to have tons of cheers coming in constantly. And when I was removed from the Twitch Partner Program for no legitimate reason,
hateful slurs.
I lost all of that.
When he says no legitimate reason, it makes it sound like they just simply removed him and nothing else happened after that. They didn't send him an email why, that they conducted an investigation into repeated instances of hateful slurs. That's the exact quote. Repeated instances of hateful slurs. What a hateful slurs, you lame brain pieces of dumb fucking shit.
Uproot my entire following and bring it over here and put it down on YouTube.
Bruh, it's literally a new tab. You press Control N and it opens a new tab, and then you write twitch.tv, right? And then the website opens. And this website is where he used to host his entire business back in the day. This website. That is Twitch, that you actually can't see right now. But I open in a different tab. That's all they had to do. He's acting like he was fucking Moses walking across the Red Sea.
And a lot of people didn't come over.
Oh, I needed
to. No gifted subs or
this massive change.
There's a lot lost. I'm making way less monthly on YouTube.
Good evening, Elite Reptilian, dude.
And I'm living with that, which is why I've tried to urge people, please tip of how important it is. I just had 2 to 3 days here where it's like, you know, low income.
Low income, you know.
And there's nothing I can do about that.
Low income, you know what I mean? Needs to be high. Needs to be this much.
Entertaining streams. The attendance is good on the streams. People are telling me they like the streams.
Okay.
It just sucks. That's the nature of the beast when you're a content creator, is that you don't know what you're going to make. You just don't. One day could be outstanding and one day could
be bad.
But
this was the most stable job you've had with the most consistent income. Except for when it's
I've
not.
I've had a series of bad days this particular week, and it's like, now what's going to happen the next week? I don't even know. You guys are clamoring for me to play new games that I can't afford. By the way, I don't even know if I can afford my bills in the next week, you know? And that's the life I'm living right now. It sucks ass, okay?
Sucks ass. I love my life.
So, I love my life. I love my life.
It's just simple, guys. If you want to help out, please do. Whether that means
your life
me
is
today,
nothing.
Or whether that means you can maybe send some digital codes my way for various networks. And again, anything
various networks, WWE Network,
Xbox Live or PlayStation, we'll
Hulu,
make it work, whatever it is.
But Netflix.
Go towards the games I've already talked about.
I just want him to be a reaction channel already. That's coming. He is someday going to be just a reaction channel, and he's going to be watching YouTube trending videos and memes. And then it's going to be the gimmick of my members are going to send me the videos to react to, and I'm going to react about it, and I'm going to give my impressions. That's going to be Phil someday. 1000%. It's just inevitable. That's one of the things that is going to happen, because that's where we're going. Eventually, he's not going to be able to play games all the time. He's already setting it up as getting old, which he is 40, which I don't know how much it limits you playing games, but in like 5 to 10 years, he's going to be talking about fucking politics and reviewing videos, and his chat is gonna be in like 7 day sub only mode, because then you can't call him out on his bullshit.
Whether it's gonna be now I'm having a brain fart. Guardians of the Galaxy or the GTA Collection or Battlefield later this month. These are the games that
we didn't play Battlefield. You're not gonna play Battlefield. This game is too broken for even DSP to play it.
Okay. Now something else I'm gonna say. All right.
I am
getting frustrated with how people react to certain things. People right now are doing super chats. Thank you. Super chats help this channel in the long term.
But
super
that's chats, delayed support. Thank you for your delayed support.
I will not get the benefit from until, like, at this point, if you're super chatting today, late December, I'll get some help from those super chats. And I appreciate that. All right?
December.
I don't want people now saying,
all right, I mean, it's the 3rd of November. It's literally the beginning of November. Then after November, it processes and he gets paid. What do you expect?
Phil's ungrateful because he got a bunch of super chats today and he's saying that he still needs help. Fuck you. No,
fuck
really.
You.
Again, fuck you. Because
you
know what I'm asking for. Help.
You know what I'm asking for.
Now.
Help now.
Let's see this one again. This is one of my favorite clips.
Today, and he's saying that he still needs help. Fuck you. No, really. Again, fuck you. Because you know what I'm asking for. Help now to pay for the games coming up. Now to pay my bills coming up. Now. Not things in December. Things now. You're
help
not
me.
Helping by
help
coming
me.
On this stream and being a
help
dickhead to me.
Now.
I feel like I'm being ungrateful because someone's doing a super chat. No, I'm very grateful. The super chats help, but they don't help me now. This isn't going to help me get through the next few weeks to month. It's going to help me next month. So stop with the bullshit coming in here and acting like I'm ungrateful when the problem is now, not a month and a half from now. You know, but this is how people are. They want to do everything that they possibly can do to be dickheads to me.
And he's such a nice guy. He just said fuck you to a bunch of people several times in this single stream.
Can be nasty to me.
In this single clip.
And I'm tired of it, you know?
Oh,
I'm here struggling.
I'm putting my foot down. I'm struggling. That's your fault.
I am. I'm here struggling. Doing my best every day.
Can't even work OBS.
Hold my shit together and put out fun and entertaining
I'm struggling. It's so hard, man. I need help now.
The streams, you know? I don't want to talk about every day. Oh, my God. It really killed me last week when I got a $1,500 bill, and now it's lingering on my head because I only paid a third of it, and there's still more I have to pay every month now moving forward, and the interest and fees. And by the way, I don't even have enough money to make my fucking bills paid this week. Oh, by the way, I just had two slow days. This is all the shit that's going through my head when I'm sitting here trying to entertain you guys, you know? It's fucked up. I love my life. I love my life.
Baller alert.
It is. It's fucked up. And, you know,
I love my life. I have so much fun every single day.
I don't know what else to say because I'm just tired of people being dicks to me. This is, I mean, that's the bottom
line. I'm tired of it, man.
It'd be one thing if, like, okay,
so you could just leave.
A good time on the streams, right?
Oh, and there we go. There we go. The massive Snow Carl moment. Snow Carl for 100 Swedish krona or whatever it is. I think that's what it is. Sorry, I can't listen anymore, but you made 13,000 last month. With 5,000 bills. Your bank history leaked, so we know every dollar in and out. I love you, so I'll take the ban, but please seek help for your gambling addiction. Bye, chat.
Comes on this
fucking show. Nice. The epic Snow Crawl moment.
Baller alert. Calling out Baller alert. Got no problems with Baller alert, but everybody on Baller alert and anybody else out there talking shit about me, here we go.
Here we fucking go.
Why aren't you playing
the epic DSP moment? And now he's gonna react to it, but you're not supposed to actually know what Snow Carl says because it's a troll message and he's gonna get banned.
Playing Guardians. Why aren't you playing this? Why aren't you playing that?
On DSP stream, you actually can't get the full story. You can only get the full story on a Hate Army Watch video, which is you should cut me out of context and use this as your intro. You can only get the full story on Hate Army Watch channel. And then it's fucking, you need a troll to tell you what happened for real. Cause now he's going to misinterpret everything. Now it's going to be Snow Carl. He's acting like a bitch ass.
You want to talk about being fucking
message
so
deleted
fucking reality,
instantly.
Right?
DSP didn't even get to read it.
Seriously.
Mods were on it already. I don't know what you said, man, but you're getting fucking bad.
Seriously. You want to be so fucking out of touch with reality. It blows my mind. It does. It blows my fucking mind how people are just like complete and utter dicks to me about this shit, you know? And it's just they're out of control. And again, the moronic conspiracy theorists, completely moronic shit that they say is insanely nonsensical stuff. Phil, you only have $5,000 in bills a month. Really?
That was your bankruptcy. How much more do you got?
That's what you think.
That's what you think. What else do you have? $5,000.
You right now.
That's so much fucking money. That's like one scalped PS5. One. That's so much. It's like one Bitcoin.
Between my mortgage and my taxes, just those two payments a month is more than $5,000 a month.
We're talking about business expenses. That's literally what everybody knows. The figure is $5,000 a month business expenses. Now, your mortgage, that's probably not a business expense. And your water bill, which is not a business expense. Because you don't live in an office building. You don't rent an office. You work from home. So all that shit, that's not a business expense. We're talking even more, if we actually have to talk about business expense, things get even more suspicious. Because the business expense guy, all he has to do for his business is pay Game Pass, pay the PlayStation Plus, pay the Xbox Gold or whatever it's called, the online portion, and all those subscription stuff that is just like Nintendo and shit like that. And then buy video games. All right? Okay, and then things get more suspicious. How does that all that shit make 5,000? And you still make way more than that. And then it's all gone immediately.
Just my mortgage and my taxes alone, I'm paying more than $5,000 a month. You're a moron. Really, if you want to see...
I'm supposed to know his bills. And if I don't know his bills that he declared and apparently is not correct, then I'm a moron for reading his information, listening to his bankruptcy call. I'm a moron for listening to it and believing literally what he said.
The company's name is Burnell Productions.
Remember this?
The company's name is Burnell Productions. It's internet content creation of on-demand and also live.
Yeah, this fucking business.
Sit here and you want to be a part of this dumb fuck conspiracy theory cult on the internet about me.
You are being part of a cult.
Brain dead stupid. Really. You are the dumbest motherfucker.
Okay. You, a person who is just sitting here and calling him out, because he is full of shit and he is very inconsistent in what he says and he ends up contradicting himself all the time. You, for questioning all of that, you are in a cult for having this discussion on the internet, whether or not this guy is full of shit. You are in a cult. But the people that have phrases attached to them such as buy in and believe everything that I say and unless you hear it from me, that's not true. Don't listen to anybody else. And those people who literally have to pay money to be in his circle and to be like actually kind of respected, they are not in a cult. They're on the bright side of this. I understand everything now.
You don't know anything.
You don't know anything. Am I supposed to know about your fucking taxes and your fucking business?
Literally have your head so far supposed to know about asses it. That you don't want to live in the real world. And one day you're going to become an adult. Really, one day you're going to be...
I fucking love this. I fucking love this. This is like an alcoholic deadbeat dad giving you a shitty fucking talk. One day you're going to get as old as I am. You're going to see life is not that fucking easy. Alcoholism, it fucking sucks, man.
Forced to, whether you like it or not. One day you're going to grow up.
One day, all right.
And you're going to become an adult.
Who are you talking to?
All right.
And who are you talking to?
You're going to have to deal with reality of how shit happens when you're an adult.
All right.
You have all these responsibilities constantly. All
right.
And all this is on you. All
right. I manage them and even have enough time to sit here and make fun of Phil. So the point is.
Shoulders. And you have to deal with things day in, day out.
And I also don't have a massive big ups to Dominic for the...
I love it.
For the 25 buck tip, dude. Big ups. Thanks, I appreciate this very much. Here's some applause.
Baller alert. Baller alert.
Big ups. Baller alert. So, yeah.
Stressful things that come up you don't expect. And now on top of that, in my life, not only do I have all the regular responsibilities of a normal adult, I have to deal with scumbags on the internet who want to fuck with my life.
Scumbags and mental cases.
Trying to ruin things left and right. Fucking with me. Really trying to fuck. Seriously.
Seriously, like, who's getting banned now? Someone got message deleted. What was that message deleted? And that's all he did, though. He leaned in on one guy.
With me.
Explosive deleted or something. Oh, we're out of touch. You have,
with scumbags.
Spent literally thousands of dollars. I can't see this because it didn't scroll. But it already got banned. It's kind of hard to get to.
All the time.
You spent thousands of dollars on your day off. On in bank statements show it, you're a complete liar. This gets deleted.
And now on top of that, in my life, not only do I have all the regular responsibilities of a normal adult, I have to deal with scumbags on the internet who want to fuck with my life all the time.
Scumbags and mental cases on the internet
left and right.
Still
fucking
me.
With me. Really trying to fuck seriously.
Seriously, like, I'm serious. I'm being super serial right now.
Are you out of your fucking mind? And I'm supposed to sit here and just take the abuse, right?
There's not supposed to be abuse in the first place. And if you were a normal streamer, there wouldn't be abuse. There probably wouldn't be. Or at least it would be 1% of what he is experiencing right now. Like, actually 1%.
No, fuck you.
That would probably be a guy from some point, at some point coming in his chat saying, oh, this guy, look at his fucking goatee. It looks like shit. Or he's balding or whatever. But if he was like a normal guy, this would never be happening. Nobody would be suspicious about how much money he makes, about how much money he spends. It wouldn't be even in discussion.
Had enough of it.
No, you get to your breaking point.
I'm trying to be here and be entertaining and being fun. And
I'm just trying to be fun, you know, man.
I'm just trying to have a good time with all of you. That's all it's about. All I want to do is sit here and have a good time
and chill
every day with my viewing audience. That's what I do this for. This, in a lot of ways, these streams are relaxing to me. These streams are, in a way, they release me from the stress and everything. You know what I mean? I like that. I come and I get to forget about the stress of this shit and just, you know, go into games and have good fun with games and chill with you guys. I love the conversations we have on the streams.
What conversations?
They allow me to have fun interactions and we talk and learn and, you know, it's great.
Somebody buys this?
I don't need to fucking be here.
I love the interactions and the chill
on the stream. All right. And have people
so lame here
being disgusting to me constantly. Sneak dissing.
Sneak dissing.
Fucking behind, you know what I mean? And that's what it is.
What is sneak dissing?
To try to.
And there was somebody else also calling him out that got deleted. Let's see if I can find him.
Here.
DSP is going to be a monkey. Constantly. Says DSP Gaming, don't worry tonight. Jin and Gacha Bender will make things better. 100%. I stand by this.
Fucking behind, you know what I mean? And that's what it is. They do this.
So relaxing.
To try to have it build up and stress me out. And I've had it. I just want to have a good time.
The guy that makes everything about his personal life and about how it's in a negative way. It's not even talking about his personal life in a positive way, where it's like cool things happening. He's driving Lamborghinis, living in mansions, like dating models and stuff. No, he got to talk about the shitty things that are happening in his life. But that's relaxing and enjoyable.
On my streams at this point, you know? I don't want to have this fucking abuse. I'm tired of it. And I have to put up with it every day, you know? Oh, see, Phil is out of touch with his audience because he won't play Metroid Dread and he won't play Guardians of the Galaxy. I would love to drop everything right now and play them. I mean, I wouldn't drop Visage because it's a really good game. But you know what I'm saying? Like, if that was the case, I would play either one instead of Condemned Criminal Origins. Do you think that out of nowhere I just decided I want to play Condemned Criminal Origins, a game from 100 years ago? No, because I have nothing else I can do. I have no money. You know?
Can't do anything else.
You know what
can't
I mean?
Do anything else. My laptop's still going crazy, by the way. I probably need to reinstall.
So that's the situation I'm in. And I seriously hope that you guys will understand, or at least try to understand, the situation that I'm in and where I'm coming from. All right.
Like, I actually really, can't.
Like, it's
I
so
actually
frustrating
can't.
To me.
I really can't. That's why we're all here, because we can't understand. And we're trying to figure out, is this guy really this full of shit to like a level where it's completely unbelievable? Or he's right about everything, or it's a mixed bag between he's incredibly full of shit and then some things are true. Like with a catfish. Like with that shit. The escort.
My life.
That shit was bullshit, and with this, he was right, but then all this other nonsense that he's obviously lying about and hiding and being completely non-transparent with.
Financial shit, and then the streams and everything, and I gotta have scumbags coming to stream and being nasty to me every day, alright? And sometimes you gotta say good riddance to bad rubbish, because I'm seeing a couple people are basically like exploding in the stream chat. People who, oh, they pretend like they support me. They
yes,
pretend like they're positive, and they're not.
By the way, I put this in one of my songs as an intro. I put quite a bit of clips from this one.
They're shitheads. They sit here and they sneak this and they say underhanded things. They try to literally bring up either detractor memes or literal drama shit every day. They do it on purpose so that they can try to derail the shit that I'm doing on my streams, you know? And it just gets to the point where it's so frustrating.
Like that, those toxic assholes.
Oh, it wasn't this. It wasn't this. Wait, it was some other clip.
I just want to have fun, man. I really just want to fucking have fun. That's it. That's all I want to do is have fun with you guys.
Oh, this is, yeah, this is it.
It's like exploding in the stream chat. People who, oh, they pretend like they support me. They pretend like they're positive, and they're not. They're shitheads. They sit here and they sneak this, and they say underhanded things. They try to literally bring up, either detractor memes or literal drama shit every day. They do it on purpose so that they can try to derail the shit that I'm doing on my streams, you know? And it just gets to the point where it's so frustrating.
I just want to have fun, man. I really just want to fucking have fun. That's it. That's all I want to have to do is have fun with you guys.
Fun, 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 fun. Way more fun. Fun, 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 fun. I just want to have fun, 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 fun. Way more fun. Fun, 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 fun. I just want to have fun.
Baller Alert, calling out Baller Alert. Got no problems with Baller Alert, but everybody on Baller Alert and anybody else out there talking no shit taxes. About me, here we go. I'm lurking and I'm stalking.
I looked at myself in the mirror and I based myself.
I just
want to
have fun, 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 fun. Way more fun, 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 fun. I just want to have fun, 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 fun. Way more fun, 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 fun. I just want to have
no taxes.
All right, that was the song segment.
What fucking garbage?
But yeah, I like using those bullshit fucking clips.
People do when they come in, man.
When he's like contradicting himself because the whole song is about him having a great life, and then I put the fucking you know what I mean.
Seriously.
Sound good.
Swaggins can't even eat a Subway sandwich right now. He can't. He's trying. He's trying so hard.
Swaggins can't eat a sandwich,
and he can't because people are such scumbags.
I thought Swaggins was gone since Sekiro, but no, he's back. Never gonna be
actually,
gone.
Actually, by the way, you shouldn't be eating a Subway sandwich. You should go get something better.
When the song gonna be available?
Dare you eat a disgusting Subway
I don't know.
Sandwich, Swaggins.
When I finish it, because like half of it, there's nothing to it. So yeah.
Okay.
I guess I gotta finish.
Anyway.
But you can listen to it on SoundCloud, I guess. I can send the link in chat if you care about it. I'll actually make it
in
public
a nutshell,
as well.
Because I don't want to talk about this all day. If you want to help me out right now, there's several ways you can help me out. Here are the real ways you can help me out right now in the short
term.
Here's
the real ways.
Tip me, because if you tip me, that's money I can use to pay bills, or it's money that I can use to buy a game, or donate some kind of credits to one of the gaming networks, whether it's Nintendo
Rick Sanchez, I have already, there's not going to be a DSP album, but I have two EPs that are out, so we can go and listen to them. You can find them on this channel.
Come on. Whether it's Xbox Live or PSN, which would obviously be upcoming for Guardians and for the GTA trilogy, and then later this month, Battlefield, and anything else that comes up this month, because I'm sure what happens is there's always a few things that kind of pop up during the course of a month, okay? That's what you can do to help, all right? That is what you can do to help. Coming onto the stream and saying shit, you
like
know
what
I mean?
Like Phil.
Phil just doesn't, he's not like in this line with the viewers and fans. And he's not playing the games we want.
Phil is out of touch.
And fucking Metroid Dread right now. That's not productive. That doesn't help. That just means that you're a shithead. Really? Because now that I told you the situation I'm in, that just makes you an entitled shithead to come on here and
entitled.
Saying, I don't respect
entitled
Phil. As a person or a content creator.
Yes.
I just want to come on here and I want to make him feel bad constantly by saying.
Not necessarily, but if you got to be called out, call him out.
Wants to.
I mean, I obviously don't like him as a person or a content creator, and pretty much anything else.
And he can't. So let me be a dickhead to him, all right? So if you say that shit, you're out of here. And I'm not putting up with it anymore. I'm just not, you know, I'm too nice is what it is. I'm too nice of a person. And I let people come on here and
he is too nice. He is too nice. The guy that is naturally, genuinely toxic to everything. He's too nice.
Come on and reference detractor shit all the time. Fucking Snow Carl has been doing it for how many months? And I'm just trying to be a nice guy.
Snow Carl. No, you're trying to be a nice guy because he gave you money. That's why you're trying to be a nice guy. Because he was giving you fucking super chats all the time. And now you're pretending, oh yeah, I was self-aware the whole time he was trying to make fun of me.
And everything.
I was self-aware this whole time. I was just too nice to say anything.
You know, I'm trying to be a nice guy. And how many times can I put up with that? You know, if that was the real one, I'm assuming it's the real one. People are saying it's the real one. But you see, I'm just too nice of a fucking guy where I let people throw these barbs at me. People tell me all the time, actually, that other streamers don't put up with that shit. Oh, you know, you go on there, you get instant banned if you try to say anything like that. I try to maintain a nice chill atmosphere on my stream so that everyone is welcome and everyone can have a good time. That's my intention on my streams, you see? But if these people are going to be like this, if these people are going to be like this, I can't have it, you know? I'm not going to have people abusing me constantly on my streams. So, you know, I have to say, if that was the real Snow Carl, that's unfortunate. But, man, what a fucking idiot, you know? Obviously, he didn't want to be here to begin with. He was here just to do this, like I said, this.
Oh, he was here to do things early and to provide, delayed support.
So,
through the super chats. What a moron.
Yeah, Zen Shuriken, here's the thing. He says Phil's pretty lenient on sneak dissing.
But the thing was that he was a moron this whole time. Now DSP realizes, no, Carl, he was a moron this whole time, but I was just too nice. And I let him abuse me and make fun of me because he was sending a dollar.
I personally, okay. Oh, was it a fake snow, Carl? If it was, I'm glad to hear.
Of course,
that.
A fake
if
snow,
that was
Carl.
A real snow, Carl. That's actually very unfortunate. Yeah. Because I don't, you know, snow, Carl. He always. Snow
oh, and now Carl, we walk it back. We walk it back. Oh, it might have been fake. Wait, he can still give me money.
Tends to get involved with stuff that he knows he shouldn't, and I talk to him about it. And I'm like, dude, just lay off. Just lay off.
Yes, be talking to Snow, Carl. How did you talk? Did you have like a email conversation on Discord, the secret Discord?
No, because he has to understand that some of the stuff
email?
He brings up actually is harmful.
Maybe
to
Telegram?
Me and my family, too. Some of the shit that he asks.
What? Like what?
So I don't
like
know
what?
If that's really him or not.
But like what?
I hope it's really not him.
Harmful for my family.
Shit, fucking shame. But anyway.
So
oh,
harmful,
you think so? Swaggins thinks it was the real one. That's just fucking unfortunate. And that guy... I don't know, man.
Trust Swaggins, always.
All right. Anyway, that's the deal. I don't want to talk about it anymore. Now I got off.
Well,
my
you talked about it for like 40 minutes already.
You guys know the deal. If you want to help me the most right now,
and he talks about it for 8 more minutes.
Tip me today.
Very nice.
Or send me via email some credits. Some people are saying, I guess digital code still exists.
He summarizes this whole thing like 4 times. This is like probably the 3rd or 4th time he reminds you that he needs tips and credits and everything to buy games. And this is the bottom line. The bottom line is give me stuff. And don't listen to anybody that says you shouldn't be giving me stuff. You should give me stuff all the time. And never stop giving me stuff because I will never not need stuff to be given to me. Never. It never stops.
We're sending me code.
And actually never will. And the more stuff you give me, the more I will believe that you should keep giving me stuff. And I will make you feel guiltier and guiltier the more you give me stuff.
For games years
but
ago,
please keep giving stuff.
They had to start sending me credit codes because the codes didn't exist anymore. If they exist,
codes
great.
Didn't exist.
Whatever. That's like water under the bridge. Who cares? Why contradict me? If you want to help, help. You know, don't forget about the contradictions. You know.
Now
Chicken
let's.
Man says, Snow Crawl
what are they saying in chat?
Tips. That is true. That is true.
Oh, that is true. Maybe he wanted something that everybody would see in chat that you can't hide that much. Because a tip, like the message's not going to come out, or DSP is going to say, oh, look, it's Stalker. I said you a fucking tip with something stupid. Why am I even bothering? All right, now let's look at chat for somebody right. who agrees
let's
with me.
Shout-outs.
Let's get
the already, look, it's already
shout-outs.
Noon.
What is going to be the first bait? Okay. Shout out to Baitmaster69 for asking Phil, why do you have so many
right,
bills?
So Nathan Smith did a very generous super chat. And I appreciate that, Nathan.
Okay.
I really do.
But I'm going to berate you.
Contribute and thank you. That will help me long term. That's not going to help me at all with my short term problems, but that will definitely help me in the long term. So thank you for that. He says, oh.
That's a very nice shout out. This guy sent me a very generous, kind, and positive super chat, but it's not helping me. So thanks for fucking nothing, loser. But anyways, here's what the fucking idiot says in his message. Oh, Phil, I like your fucking videos, and I've been watching you for a long time. Well, fucking thanks for the support.
This helps, and the message I sent yesterday was how Call of Duty Zombies looks like it's Hades, as in you choose what upgrades you want.
This is a classic bit. Now we're talking about fucking upgrades in Hades.
But the problem is people aren't asking for stuff on Game Pass. They're literally screaming at me.
What? Wait. We crack. What?
Super chat says, how about new stuff on Game Pass? Lots of variety. Oh, again, agility, I'm sure there is. But the problem is people aren't asking for stuff on Game Pass. They're literally screaming at me. Why didn't you play Metroid Dread? Why didn't you play Guardians? Why won't you play them? Why do you keep avoiding them? I don't think that playing anything on Game Pass randomly is going to appease people like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, they want the whatever's new or hot, and I missed 2 games in October. Admittedly, Guardians was one that went right under my nose because no one knew it was going to be good. And I would love to play them, but I can't right now because of the situation, you know?
Because of the situation. The economy is
so
bad.
Bill, here we go. Bill Hicks resurrected.
Oh, and of course, we already are mocking him. We don't even know. As a casual viewer, you're just watching DSP. You don't know what that guy says in his tip. You already know the twist is that he is an asshole and he's wrong and he's stupid.
Did a super chat and claims, if you go to Amazon.com and you type in Metroid Dread game code, it'll bring you to a place where you can buy the digital code. Maybe that is the case for Nintendo. You may be right. I know
at least in the last few years, when I was getting everything on PlayStation, people were telling me that wasn't the case anymore. That they wanted to buy me game codes. They couldn't, so they had to send me the code to get the credit on the store.
In the US, you can probably buy like gift cards for PlayStation and keys like that for cheaper than they actually go on some of those sites. If you want to actually do the thing, you can do that. Probably, if you're in the US. But for the other regions, especially here, I can't do that. I can't have somebody send me send me the Dutch game code for PlayStation so I can buy a game. What the
manually,
fuck?
Because apparently the game codes didn't work anymore. You couldn't directly just send someone a code to get a game. Maybe it's different on Nintendo Store, okay?
Oh yeah, remember when people went to see Spider-Man, but they didn't tip DSP, and there was a little rant about that, about people would rather go and watch a movie than tip DSP.
Parasolo, thanks for the super chat. I don't care.
Dare you spend money on anything that is not necessary when you can spend it on Phil, a guy who giving him money is really, really not necessary.
No nut November. I'm an adult.
It's
just
no nut every day for him.
All the trolling is getting old. What's
since
the point?
Nut.
The thing is,
could he have PTSD from the accident and literally never bust a nut since then? That would be hilarious.
What it is they really want to break me down. They do at this point, like. These idiots
want to break me down, but I never give up. I keep asking people for money and they give it to me. I never give up. I still hope for the best. That's his business tactic from way back in the day. Just hope for the best, man. And just keep doing the exact same shit you've been doing the whole time. And eventually claim that you rebranded or you changed something while it's actually fundamentally kind of the same thing with little cosmetic changes. But that's how business works.
Absolutely everything. They really have. I mean, when you get to the point where you've committed crimes, multiple crimes against someone, whether it's swatting, doxing, fucking, you know what I mean?
Doxing. Identity he revealed his own fucking information. He literally showed it on camera. Fucking doxing.
And they can, and now it's what? Well, instead, let's fucking break down Phil
psychologically. Let's break down Phil right? psychologically.
Let's make it so that now, let's make him feel like shit on every stream. Let's have a bunch of people come on his stream saying terrible things about his wife, saying terrible things about him, that he doesn't want to play the games, he's out of touch with his audience. You know what I mean? Like, they're literally doing every possible thing. And you're right. It's like to the point where, you know, it's like another drop in the river. I guess that's the best way to describe it. It's another drop in the river. It's constant. It's constant bad feelings and abuse. So to see it, it's like, but you know, what really frustrates me is when I have a month now, like I really want to put out the best stuff for you guys in November. I do. I absolutely want to put out the absolute best content for you that I can. And I can't because of financial limitations. And then people have to be blatantly lying.
Blatantly lying. About what?
Lying about me.
Why? About the champion stuff? That is true. Get over it. That is actually true. Either stop doing it and you're going to be better, or keep doing it and you're going to be worse. But it is true. That is the actual in reality.
That's not going to fly anymore. I just can't. I have to
How is it not going to fly? What changed since then? What changed? Really nothing. Really nothing. Except that the day before, he claimed that all the leaks are completely fake. But they're based on things that are real, but they're completely fake. So all of it is both fake and based on real stuff that has real snippets of truth in it. Very much makes sense.
No, because this kind of pre-stream is what they want, but it's what I have to do when I'm at my limit.
I gotta do it. I gotta bet.
I'm a human, and I get to my fucking limit.
Gotta ask.
I have to respond at some point. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Bill Hicks did another super chat. So you can 100% buy digital game codes on Amazon. Again, if it's Nintendo, then maybe you're correct. I don't know about anything else. I really don't. I don't know about anything else.
He doesn't even know what to beg for. Doesn't even know that.
So the first tip.
I don't know. You can send me if you want to do shit. Go research it. Then spend the money. Send it to me so I can maybe even consider doing it. That's why I'm telling you all the shit that people do to put in effort for, like, not intros because that shit is trolls, for like fan art and thumbnails and bullshit like that. All that effort is just him believing that you are doing him a favor.
Today is from
actually,
Bob,
he's doing you a favor for using
it. Your boy Bob for getting the tip.
And you do this to get acknowledgement for him because he is just so special and so fucking good.
Started today. Let's get that on the leaderboard.
Yeah, the Amazon wish list, that I believe is still a thing. Probably still. And I think this is the end of this clip.
There's tips. All right.
Now we're counting tips like a stripper, and he has $5 after this, after flashing the bills. What is this?
Hit the tips goals today. I mean it. Like today, especially with everything going on, the fact that the last 2 days, we didn't hit the tips. The last 2 days, this is all we hit. That's it. We didn't even hit a hat goal. So I didn't even get to 2/3 of the amount of tips that I need to raise to basically make ends meet and afford my basic shit. Okay, that's the situation I'm in. And then I got people screaming at me that I don't want to spend money on games. It's like, fuck you. You know, like I said, next week, I got a ton of bills to pay. And I got to put up with this psychological abuse of these fucking shitheads coming on here every day. So, guys, hopefully,
no. Today. No. All right,
I'm about to get scared shitless with Visage.
Oh, yeah.
Here's what's going to happen, though. I'm going to go on break.
And we're going on break. After a massive, astounding rant for 40 minutes and only $5 in tips. Now somebody's going to probably drop in like $50.
A bunch of people are going to leave the stream, and that's okay. A lot of people just came here for drama this morning. They got their dose of drama. They got to see supposedly Snow Carl get banned for being a shithead.
Supposedly.
And now they get to move on.
Can't even confirm shit that is happening in his own chat.
I'm okay with that. For those of you who are here to ask,
can't even trust him about that. Supposedly something happened today on my own stream.
Enjoy games and have fun with me.
That was a big deal and people reacted very strongly to it, but I don't know. It was supposed. It was allegedly.
Today, welcome. You know, all the regulars, welcome. How you doing? I hope that you're ready for a normal day because it's going to be a normal day. I'm not going to let this shit bother me. I'm not going to let this shit derail my streams all day. I got what I had to say off my chest. You guys know the deal now, right? You know what's going on with me. If you'd like to help, please, by all means, do. And let's see how today goes. Okay.
All right,
guys.
There's more. No, that's it. And that's the Snow Carl tweet. Not the tweet, but the comment. And I guess that's it for the stream. Thanks, everybody, for the early lurking and stalking when you least expect it. Listen to this fun.
People who, oh, they pretend like
this fun song. And that's gonna be it. Thanks, everybody. Again, thank you for your charitable contributions, your delayed support. Your live support in real time, in fake time, everything. Big ups.
So that they can try.
And I'm gonna be lurking, stalking when you least expect it.
You know.
And
it just gets to the point where it's so frustrating.
I don't know. When you hear the baller alert, I'm gonna come.
I just wanna fucking have fun.
And I'm gonna bust.
All I wanna have to do is have fun with you guys.
Baller alert.
Fun. Way more fun. Fun.
I just wanna have
fun. Way more fun.
I just want to have no taxes.
Baller Alert, calling out Baller Alert. Got no problems with Baller Alert, but everybody on Baller Alert and anybody else out there talking shit about
no taxes.
Me, here we go.
I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it.
You're still on mission one.
Fun.
Get a real fucking job.
Fun.
You're begging.
Fun.
Fun.
I just want to have no taxes.
Dark side Phil's erroneous use of tips and bits to fund his addiction to wrestling pixels.
That was my depression. Cuck life, 100%. Live the life of the cuck, why not?
Get a real fucking
baller alert.